Welcome to the Christian Internet Sportsnet. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chapel. John couldn't be here tonight. Yeah. He's on the road. He's down in Tennessee doing some volleyball games.
Doing a whole bunch of them.
Okay.
National Association of Christian Athletes Tournament. I'd tell you what town I'm in, but I can't remember now. Just north it doesn't matter.
Yeah, well, either way. So anyway, welcome to Becker Field. The Wildcats are hosting Peoria Heights tonight. Peoria Heights is a 5-4 team. They come from the Prairie Land Black Conference.
Very good. Okay.
So just a little...
You were talking about their offense a while ago.
Yeah,
fill us in on that.
Kind of going through their offense. So Peoria Heights actually only played 8 games this year. They had a forfeit for their last game of the year. So through 8 games, they have a – let me find my notes here. They have a quarterback, Blake Bagner. He is 107 for 194. He's thrown for 1,530 yards with 12 touchdowns. They have a sophomore running back, Gino Hess. He's going to be one you'll probably hear a lot about tonight. He's got 1,238 yards rushing and 16 touchdowns. And it looks like Blake's number one target for passing is wide receiver Jaron Wallace with 45 catches, 803 yards, and 9 touchdowns. Sorry.
To get in the state tournament, they actually had the forfeit for the last game.
They
qualified them for their fifth win.
Yeah, they gave them the 5-4 record. So yep.
We kind of think that you and I think you think I do, that Wilmington should be able to handle this game.
Yeah.
But when they start talking about these passing numbers, I start getting nervous.
Yeah, Wilmington has struggled a little bit with the pass, giving up some big plays. Not so much the little plays, but the bigger plays down the field. So you can probably maybe expect one or two big plays. But Wilmington does a really good job pressuring the quarterback.
Yes, that's going to be – I think that's number one key to their defense. They can pretty well handle the run most of the time. But if they don't get to that quarterback, these are those guys out in the island, because he puts them one-on-one. And I think that'd drive me crazy as a defensive guy.
Defensive back relying on your defensive line to get through and get some pressure on the quarterback. But we'll see what happens. Peoria Heights comes from a 1A, 2A conference. I think they had one conference opponent that was a 3A opponent. So they're used to playing smaller schools. Last year, they go 0-9. This year, 5-4, they co-opt is what happened. They became a bigger school because they co-opt with, I believe it's Quest Academy in Peoria as well. So that bumped them up to the 3A, the Class 3A.
Oh, okay. And then tonight for our Wilmington Wildcats, we have those key injuries. We have Nick Preto. You said he might be in tonight.
At Cap Eckers the other night, Coach was saying that Nick was starting to practice a little bit and that we might see him tonight. I believe Tyler Breimer, he will be out after getting a little dinged up there in the Mantino game, as well as we might see, I'm drawing a blank, Ben Studer might be back tonight.
Oh, good.
Coach said they got his hand all clubbed up. He might not play center because the guy they brought in, Cox, who's been playing center, is doing a really good job. So they might actually use Studer to spell the other guys while he gets back into football rhythm.
Boy, that'd be a real help to keep him nice and healthy and let him get back into his full game plan before we get into these other teams down the road.
Right.
But right now, we've got more trouble right now. We want to stay with this game here.
Yeah,
get ahead of ourselves.
We got this game here. There are a couple other games going on around the I-8. Also going on tonight, a big game for the Wilmington's kind of keeping an eye on is Lyle is at Byron. The winner of that game is who will play. If Lyle wins, we would be traveling to Lyle next week. If Byron wins, Byron would be coming here. Last year, we played Byron in the semifinal matchup.
Yes.
And it was, I think, not that good of a game for Byron.
No, it wasn't too hard a game for Wilmington. They had a pretty easy time of it.
Yeah, both Lyle and Byron at 7-2. Byron had some issues at the beginning of the year, some injuries and some disciplinary issues, from what I understand, is the reason they lost a game or two there at the beginning. But they've righted the ship, and they seem to just be on a roll.
Kind of the same way with Lyle. Lyle started out kind of tentative the first part of the year, but the farther they've gone, the tougher they've gotten.
Yeah, Coach was saying the other night at Catbackers that the starting quarterback isn't got hurt, like running out onto the field for practice, or I sorry, it's a little hazy, but so they put a backup in, which was a running back, and he has excelled at the quarterback position for Lyle.
Wow. Sometimes accidents are some of the best things that happen to the team, you know?
Right.
Somebody steps up and you're not expecting them.
So a couple other games going on in the I-8 tonight. We got number 12 Hersher at number 5 Mantino. So that should be an interesting. Mantino really had no problems with Hersher during the regular season. They believe they played him the first game of the year. So kind of expect Mantino to win there. Hersher's been kind of struggling as of late.
Well, Hersher, you never know what you're getting on a given night. One night they'll play a real tough game. The next night they kind of like a pushover. So it kind of depends on who shows up in a particular evening. But I'd go with you. I'd go with Mantino. I think he'll come out of that one alive.
Right. And the late is number 15 Cole City at number 2 Marengo. Who's 9-0? I believe Marengo is one of Byron's losses this year.
Oh, okay. Yeah, Cole City hasn't had a real good year this year. They've kind of been mediocre for their team. They usually have a big group up front, have a tough line, but I think I have to go with Marengo too. I think they're gonna.
Yeah, they had one of their best games they played was against that first game against Wilmington, and then
after that it was downhill.
It was kind of downhill from there.
Yeah.
And then tomorrow we have Norridge Ridgewood at number 7 Plano. Both teams 7-2. Plano lost last week to Lyle.
That's another one I don't understand. Plano started the first year. They look like they're almost invincible.
Yeah, they played Mantino, got their first loss, came back next week, and put 50 points up on Cole City.
And I wouldn't have believed that.
No.
And I thought, man, nobody's going to score 50 on Cole City. And boy, they did. And then they got to last year, and they really got whipped by Lyle. I mean, that was a pretty good thrashing.
Yeah.
And I didn't expect that at all.
All right, so let's go ahead and we'll play up a couple commercials, and we'll come back after that and talk to you some more. We got about 12 minutes left until the Intel kickoff.
And we We appreciate Breeze of Construction being our pregame sponsor. We don't have the coach interview because John, our interviewer, went south for the winter. And when he gets back next week, hopefully we're still playing. He'll be back with the coach's time.
As our guest to the first round. Breezer Construction Company is a proud supporter of Wilmington Wildcats football on the Christian Internet Sports Network. For over 30 years, Breezer Construction Company has led the way in providing quality construction to the industrial, utility, and pipeline industries. For more information on Breezer Construction Company, go to breezerconstruction.com. That's breezerconstruction.com or call 815-521-0900. Ricchetti's Cafe and Pizzeria in downtown Cole City is an authentic Italian restaurant that's all about sharing great food in a relaxing atmosphere. Ricchetti's has delicious paninis, sandwiches, calzones, salad, pasta, and of course their incredible pizza. Plus, you can check out a game on one of their many TVs, and they have Wi-Fi too. Stop by Ricchetti's Cafe and Pizzeria today at 375 South Broadway in Cole City. ACN representative Pete Treby has a very simple way for you to save money on your monthly bills. All you have to do is go to Pete's website and fill out the free analysis form. Then Pete will show you a detailed way to save money on everything: wireless, satellite TV, high-speed internet, local and long distance, computer support, and coming soon, save money on energy. Go to the sponsors page on this website, click on ACN representative Pete Treby's link, fill out the free analysis form, and start saving money today. Quigley Technology Services is your local source for computer help. They have built numerous websites, including ours here at the Christian Internet Sports Network. Quigley Technology Services also specializes in virus removal, so your computer will get back to full speed now. and you can trust them for first-class computer repair, including free local pickup and delivery, plus on-site service, including after hours. Contact Quigley Technology Services at 815-293-7844 or stop by at quigtech.com. That's QUIGtech.com.
Teresa's Styling Salon in Wilmington is a casual, family-friendly salon that caters to people of all ages. Teresa's provides everything from haircuts to perms to manicures, and they can highlight or color your hair for that special look. Teresa's is located in the Southgate Plaza on Water Street in Wilmington. Call today for an appointment at 815-476-1955. That's 815-476-1955.
Phelan Acres Bible Church is the perfect place if you are looking for a church to call home. They have services every week, including Sunday school at 9:45, morning worship at 11, and Wednesday night prayer meetings at 7. Phelan Acres Bible Church is located at 26009 Willow Lane in Wilmington, Illinois. And for more information, call 815-476-7818. That's 815-476-7818.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chapel here at Becker Field.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Getting ready to, Wilmington Wildcats are getting ready to host the Peoria Heights Patriots.
In color guard with band director
Georgia. Looks like we're going to have the national anthem now. So maybe we might have to take one more break, then we'll come back after the national anthem and see if we can set up our game for tonight.
If you're looking for more information on Wilmington Wildcats football, then check out the Catbackers every Wednesday at 7 at Tuffy's. Each week, Coach Reen goes over game film, takes questions from the audience, and presents the Offensive and Defensive Player of the Week awards. Plus, you'll get to hang out with other Wildcat fans and get the inside scoop next week's game. So be sure to check out the Catbackers every Wednesday at 7 at Tuffy's. Around your house, chances are Beth's Busy Bees can get it done. They specialize in residential and commercial cleaning, but they can also do lawn care, small home remodeling and repair jobs, and even things like caregiving. Beth's Busy Bees is a small family-owned business, and they will treat you right every time. Call 815-685-9111 for Beth's Busy Bees today. Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop specializing in top-of-the-line customer service. Warren's accepts all insurance companies, and they offer free estimates, certified technicians, and a lifetime written warranty. Plus, Warren's will set you up with a rental car while your vehicle is in the shop. So the next time you need work done on your vehicle, call my good friend Warren at 815-458-3300 or stop by Warren's Collision Center at 242 North Front Street in Braidwood. You can also check them out online at warrenscollision.com. Warren's Collision Center, where they care beyond the repair.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Sorry about that. We had to take a little break for the national anthem. But we're here. We're live from Becker Field. Got about 6 minutes till kickoff, and Wilmington first round of playoffs again.
Yep.
20 years in a row.
I was just going to ask you, how many years in a row has this been?
20 years in a row, and also this is the 10th time Wilmington has gone 9-0 in a regular season.
Really?
Yep.
I didn't actually know that either. That's amazing. Oh, how about our coin toss?
Peoria Heights won the coin toss. They elected to receive in the south end zone. Wilmington will be defending the north end zone to start the game.
So this is what Wilmington usually likes to do. They usually like to receive the ball starting the second half. So by losing the coin toss, they actually got what they wanted. At least that's what Coach usually does anyway. So I suppose he's going to do the same thing this time. Are we going to have any of the pregame stuff, the Harleys coming out? And the?
I mean, it's a little chilly out, but I believe the Harleys are here. We have the fireworks. The tunnel, all your normal, I say normal, pregame.
Yeah, I've often said if you can't be ready to play a game after the pregame thing is here, you don't have much athletic blood in you, because by the time they get done, the fireworks goes off, the Harleys are out here, they come in through the woods. By the time you get all that done, it's time to play ball, and boy, we're gonna have a lot of fun tonight. I'm looking forward to having a good time and enjoying this game.
Yeah, I mean, it's first game for me to be doing play-by-play. I sat in your seat a few weeks ago doing some color.
Oh,
with
that's
John.
Right.
It's a lot harder than people think. You sit here and you're trying to describe the game.
Yes.
And if you don't do it all the time, but John had 9 games this season to try to get everything perfected, and so yeah. It'll be a little clunky. Just stick with me, and. Yeah.
It's something he loves to do, and he just does it naturally. It's just a gift that God has given to him, and he just loves doing it. We have to try to make up for that. We're not exactly born to do that kind of stuff. Here come the Hartleys out. They are here tonight. I don't know how. Oh, they're still coming. Wow, there's a whole long line of them. We're going to have to get the – I wonder if they're going to let the – yeah, there go some guys out to start the line run through, so maybe they are going to let them do that. Sometimes they don't let them do the run through.
Yeah, it's a decent crowd for Wilmington, first-round playoffs. Not as big as some Mantino game was. Peoria looks like they traveled okay.
Not bad.
Not too bad.
For a 5-4 team that had to travel on the road, an hour and 45 minutes to get up here.
A Friday night. Back again. Try to get here, get off work, get home,
and
get everything taken care of.
All the parents that was working didn't have a chance to get off in time to get up here. And so, let's see. What are we expecting out of Peoria tonight? Expecting mostly running? Expecting mostly passing? Or what?
I have to say, they're kind of like a Westmont Mantino type offense where they're going to spread you out. They're going to hand the, you know, by the just the stats, stat wise, they're kind of even run pass, but they're going to spread you out. They're going to hand it off to their sophomore running back, or their quarterback's going to throw it down the field. And we were watching him warm up at pregame, and he was throwing, you know, 40, 50 yard passes right down the. Down the sideline with it with accuracy. So if they don't get after them, it could get interesting.
Yeah, that's when we've gotten burned this year. We've been against several quarterbacks, two or three quarterbacks that have really been able to air a ball out for high school kids in small schools. They have gone last week. I got 50 yards in the air one time. Oh,
yeah.
My land.
Yeah, it's just amazing to see some of the quarterbacks at the high school level, and you hear yet. When you go up to the NFL, you hear the problem that they don't have quarterbacks.
Yeah.
And, you know, we've seen at least 2 or 3 different quarterbacks this year alone that have been able to air out the ball.
To me, I was completely flabbergasted when he threw 50 yards in the air. I thought, what in the world? And it didn't even look like it was hard for him. It just kind of flew out of his hands, just floated out and took off down the field. And he was right on target. That was the thing. It's one thing to throw the ball that far.
Right, exactly.
Another thing to hit a guy over defender's hands on the run.
Right, in stride. Yeah, you can be it's hard to defend against a pass like that.
Well, we've got Peoria out here in their red pants, white shirts. Looks like blue numbers. Their mascot is the Patriots, so they got red, white, and blue. The Wildcats haven't come through the forest yet. They haven't come out of the woods. Everybody's out here. The Harleys are revving up. The people are standing around, and nobody's here yet. Coach is making this a pressure type of moment, I guess.
Here they come.
All right, here they come.
Music changes. You hear the ring of the bells. The fans are on their feet. Fireworks are in the air, and out come the Cats.
There's that smoke they're running through. We're ready to play ball here, boy. Oh, that's nice fireworks. I enjoy those.
Yeah, fireworks, Catbackers, that's something the Catbackers provide for every home game.
Oh, the Catbackers do.
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic. That really is a nice way to start a game.
Yeah, you know, it's something Wilmington started doing a long time ago, and a lot of teams have picked up off of it, especially the I-8 teams.
And they've set a good standard for the other schools, and of course, with their football playing the last few years, they've kind of been up there toward the standard setting of the entire league. They've been hard to beat.
Yeah, it was 8 conference champions in a row, too. That's 8 conference championships in a row.
That's amazing. Well, our Harleys are turning around and making their way back off the field. The Patriots are on the field, ready to go. And our Wilmington Wildcats are meeting around the coach one last time. And they'll be hitting the field here. We're ready to roll here. Like, I'm going to get my pencil picked up, and you're going to start talking.
Yeah, back to receive the kick is number 9, Jalen Hughes, and number 44, Geno Hess. So, Cats are still huddled up on the side. They haven't been told to get out there yet.
Here they
kick
go.
Kick off the ball. Okay, here we go.
Well,
Alex Hatton will be doing the kicking duties for the Cats tonight.
Done a good job this year, too.
Yeah, he's really, at the beginning of the year, just kind of, he's really picked it up towards the end of the year.
He's a soccer player by trade, and they've kind of enlisted him off the soccer team. One night, he finished a soccer game, came over here and put on his jersey, went out to do the kicking for the football team that night.
Yeah, he scored 2 goals in the soccer game, came back here, and I think he kicked 4 extra points and a field goal or something like that.
Oh, yeah, done a fantastic job.
All right. Whistles are blown. Here's the kick. Kick goes back. It's fielded at the 20 by number 9. He's taken down at the 30.
I think he fumbled the ball.
He might even fumble. Looks like Wilmington might have recovered. Let's see what the refs say. No indication as of yet.
But I think when he was swinging around in a circle by the tackler, the ball came out.
I see one ref saying it's Wilmington's ball. It is Wilmington's football. So number 9, Jalen Hughes, gets the ball at the 20, takes it up about 11 yards upfield, fumbles the football. Wilmington falls on it and recovers. Didn't catch who recovered that football.
Oh, I didn't either. I should have paid attention. I tell you what, that's a job the jobs on the football field, the one I wouldn't like is being the one who gets the kickoff.
Okay, so Wilmington will start on offense.
That returning job is no good.
Tredman goes out. You have McWilliams at fullback, Hawkins and Weaver at wingbacks. Here's a pitch to Hawkins. Hawkins up the middle. He cuts back, and he could be gone. He's going to the 5. He's in for the touchdown. A little iffy there. He kind of got tripped up. Wasn't sure if he made it across the line, but he's in for the touchdown. That is a statement. First play of the game, Wildcats score a touchdown.
Wow. Nick Hawkins, 31-yard touchdown run. And the Wilmington Wildcats are on the board.
They just handed off. He went right up the middle and kind of did a few cuts and took it to the outside. So Hatton will be back in to kick the extra point.
Holding the ball is Jeff Tredman, their quarterback.
There's the kick is up, and it's good. So the Wilmington Wildcats take a 7-0 lead with 11 minutes and 46 in the first. So we'll go ahead and take a commercial break and come back for kickoff.
Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop specializing in online customer service. Warren's accepts all insurance companies, and they offer free estimates by technicians and a lifetime written warranty. Plus, Warren's will set you up with a rental car while your vehicle is in the shop. So the next time you need work done on your vehicle, call my good friend Warren, 615-458-3300, or stop by Warren's Collision Center at 242 North Front Street in Braidwood. You can also .com. Warren's Collision Center, where they care beyond the repair.
If you missed it, the game started. We had fireworks and behind the field, on the field, had a fumble recovery and one play run in.
It was a total of 14 seconds of playing time.
So Alex Hatton back to kick again to, it's like the same two, Jalen Hughes and Geno Hess. His kick goes to Jalen Hughes. At about the 15, he runs it up to the 25, to the 30. And he's taken down the 34-yard line.
Showed nice speed going around the corner there. I thought maybe he might make that corner and get on down the field a little bit.
Yeah, well, the defense did a good job kick return there. So the Patriots will come out, lined up in shotgun, 3 receivers to the near side, 1 to the far side.
Boy, you weren't kidding when you're talking about spreading it out.
Here's the snap. Quarterback drops back, pass caught by number 3, Jaron Wallace. Yes, caught by Jaron Wallace. Looks like it's first down for the Patriots. Gain of about, you know, say 20 yards.
20 yards?
Yep.
Okay.
So back, quick pace on this offense.
You're going to have to get in the
Here's a snap, handoff to number nine. Number nine, he goes to cut it up the middle, cuts to the outside, takes it up to about the 41-yard line of the Cats.
A six-yard gain, second down, 4 yards to go. Well, it's almost 5 yards.
So Patriots line up. Three receivers to the near side, two to the far side. Quarterback comes to the line, maybe changes the play, backs back up in the shotgun. Motion from number nine, he drops back. Screen pass. Number 44 breaks one tackle and mobbed by pretty much every Wildcat on the field on that one. Looks like he lost about a yard or two. Geno Hess was the running back who caught that screen pass. So interesting set of plays here. So third down and seven.
Yeah, he lost two on that one. And nice job. I think it might have been Steve Smock.
Patriots are
got over there and smelled that one out. And
lined up, three receivers to the near side, one to the far. Running back Geno Hess behind the quarterback and shotgun. Shotgun snap. Quarterback drops back. Pressure. And he throws it. Another screen off to the number 44. He gets the first down and more. He's going down the sideline. And this is going to be a touchdown. Touchdown for Geno Hess. So Wildcats applying a lot of pressure here and did not cover the running back out of the backfield for another screen pass. Kind of the same play as the last time, but unfortunately, this game is now 7-6 pending the extra point.
Well, I said before the game started, the one thing I was worried about is pass defense. That's been the weakness of the Cats all year long, and they literally had nobody over there to take Hess out of the backfield.
Here's the snap. The kick is up, and it's good. So your score's all tied, 7-7. 9 minutes and 57 seconds left in the first, and we'll be back after a short commercial break.
Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop specializing in top-of-the-line customer service. Warren's accepts all insurance companies, and they offer free estimates, certified technicians, and a lifetime written warranty. Plus, Warren's will set you up with a rental car while your vehicle is in the shop. So the next time you need work done on your vehicle, call my good friend Warren at 815-458-3300 or stop by Warren's Collision Center at 242 North Front Street in Braidwood. You can also check them out online at warrenscollision.com. Warren's Collision Center, where they care beyond the repair.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chappell. We are all tied up, 7-7. Cats recovered a fumble, scored on the next play. Kicked off to Peoria Heights. Three or four plays later, it seemed like Peoria Heights was scoring a touchdown from a screen pass.
You realize we've only used up 2 minutes and 3 seconds of time. There's been two touchdowns scored, a fumble recovery.
Oh, getting your money's worth tonight.
Boy, I guess. I think better settle down to a football game or head.
So Peoria Heights gets ready to kick off. Doing the kicking duties is number 65. Is that right? Jose Perez.
65 it is?
Yeah.
I'll put him down. I think he must have
kicked a low line drive kick to Hawkins.
Dropped it.
He picks it back up. Now he runs. He's past the 25. 20 breaks a tackle. 25 to the 30. 35, 40. And he gets tackled right around the 40-yard line. About the Wildcat 40-yard line. Hawkins, that first one he broke, he really ran over somebody that just –
he ran him over. Yeah, he ran right smack him, knocked him flat.
And
that was amazing.
It's not that big of a guy, but the guy he ran over was number 58, Marcus Casely. He's a senior outside linebacker, 5'11", 200 pounds. So don't think he was ready for Nick. So Cats will start first and 10 on their own 41-yard line.
If he doesn't get a look by some Division I school, it'll be amazing. That guy can really run the ball.
What do we got going on? Trainers are going out on the field.
I wonder if the guy – it looks like they might have hit helmets. I wonder if they
– Oh, no, they're going to go over and check out the Peoria Heights
yeah,
kid who he came off the field shaking his head after Nick just lowered his shoulder and ran through him. So Cats come up to the line, tight, double wing. Hawkins on the far side, Weaver on the near side. Pitch to Weaver, breaks tackle. Now he cuts it to the outside, to the 50, to the 40, to the 30, to the 20. Nobody's catching him, to the 10, 5. Touchdown, Wildcats. Touchdown, Wildcats. This is going to be a long night. Two plays, two touchdowns. How many yards to be? Was that one?
59-yard one.
59-yard touchdown by Owen Weaver.
My
pretty land. Exciting game for a first-round playoff game.
Yeah, I wonder if anybody's going to show up and play defense yet. No, neither team has so far.
I can tell you right now, when the Cats defense came off the field, Coach Reins pulled him aside last time.
I bet and gave he had a word, yeah.
So Alex Hatton will line up here for the extra point. Here's the snap. The kick is up. Looks good. And it's good. So Wildcats take a lead 14-7 with 9 minutes and 35 seconds left in the game.
I got to get myself together. We're thankful for our sponsors for a nice game, Lucetti's Cafe and Pizzeria, ACN representative Pete Treby, Cat Backers, Teresa Styling Salon, Best Busy Bees, Quigley Technology Services, Family Acres Bible Church, Breezer Construction Company, and Warren's Collision Center. Without their help, we couldn't be bringing this, and we couldn't have used up 3 minutes with your time.
Right? So we won't cut to a commercial break of this. Do you know, like, right now we're being recorded? We're being memorialized by Mr. Jeff Dillon up there. He records
You would remind me of that.
Yeah, right? So last year, one of my terrible touchdown calls got put in there, so I figure the first one I did with Hawkins scoring his touchdown is probably going to get in the highlight DVD, too, just to embarrass me. So.
Whoa. All right, we're back here. 9:35. Oh, I didn't finish my stuff here.
Okay, so Alex Hatton will put it on the tee, get ready to kick off to Jalen Hughes and Gino Hess. I got a pen here to start trying to mark down who I can call here. Keep forgetting to call the quarterback from Peoria Heights.
All right,
here's
the
kick. It's up. Looks like it's going to go to Hughes. He drops the ball. He has And it looks like he's going to be down on about the 22-yard line. Had a hard time handling that kickoff.
He just barely got in time because one of the Wildcats hit him on the ground just as soon as he got on with the ball.
Who did you have as the quarterback? It was number 17, right?
Yes, Blake Bergner, here. Number 17.
All right.
Is it Bergner or Begner? B-E-G-N-E-R?
Begner. Begner. We'll go with Begner.
All right.
All right, so... Oh, Peoria Heights comes out. Three receivers to the far side, one to the near side. Number Gino Hess at running back and Blake at quarterback and shotgun. Here's a snap, handoff up the middle, and he's taken down. Ended up losing a yard there. Nice tackle by number 59, Caleb Gugis. So second down and all, about 11 for Peoria Heights. Back in the shotgun, three receivers to the far side, two to the near. Motion. Hand off to Hughes around the outside. Looked like he was going to get tackled behind the line, but managed to pick up about 2 yards. So third and nine. For the Patriots.
That play took too long developing.
It did.
They had a chance to pursue it from the opposite side and come in behind and tackle him from behind. And it did look like he was going to tackle for a loss or no gain, but he did manage to get a couple yards out of it.
So three receivers to the near side, two to the far.
Nobody.
Bergner and shotgun. Takes the snap. Quick throw. Number three again, and he catches it, comes down with it. Ball comes free. Let's see.
He jumped back on top
like
of
he
it.
He got it again. Got it back. It's about 12-yard pickup for Wallace. Patriots first down. First down on the Patriots 38-yard line.
They've thrown the ball four times. They've got four completions.
Like I said, the quarterback's got a pretty good arm.
Yes, he does.
He is a junior, 5'10", 150 pounds.
They're going to have to get a a Wildcat in front of him in his face.
Oh, might have either a false start or encroachment.
I think it was a false start in left tackle, or left guard, I think. But.
Yep, looks like a false start. Back him up 5 yards.
False start.
So, first and 15 from the 33-yard line.
Looks like the Wildcats were going to send a blitz in. They faked it a time or two, and it drew the from the line, offensive line.
So, Begner and Hess. Begner, the quarterback. Hess, running back. Shotgun, two receivers, far side. Moved Hess out to the slot. Snap. Pass. Right to number five, but he's here's the footsteps and ends up dropping it. Wallace, yeah, that's some good coverage there.
Good coverage. It should have been a caught ball, and he was going to be hit immediately. He wouldn't have gotten the first down, but that'll make it second down and about 15.
So second down and 15 for the Patriots. Line up in the shotgun with running back behind him, three receivers to the far side, one to the.
They're still setting up, looks like. Well, well, they got receivers all over the place.
Yeah, they keep moving around, keep guessing. Let's see if we get a screen again. That seemed to work for him, a little bubble. That's kind of what it was, a little underneath to pass to number seven. He picks up about 10 yards, but still about 5 yards short of the first down. Trying to number seven, Tyler Gregory, Jr., 5'10". 150 pounds. Seems to be all 150 pound receivers here. A little equipment issue out there. All right, here we go. Ball's whistled into play. So, third down and five on the 43 yard line for the Patriots. Three receivers to the near side, one to the far. Here's the snap, drops back, quick pass to number three, and he catches it, and a missed tackle, and then he's brought down, but they can pick up a first down and about 20 yards on the play. So they're just not getting a good inside presence on that receiver. He's getting, they're letting him to the inside, and he's
how many yards to whom?
It was to number three.
Number three, okay.
Yep, Jaron Wallace, I'd say about 20. But I could be wrong, 15-ish.
Let's see.
So first and 10, ball on the 37, the Wildcats 37-yard line. Snap, quarterback drops back, quick pass over the middle, and this one is over the head of the receiver, Jaron Wallace.
Wow.
So second and 10 for the Patriots. Patriots are picking up big chunks of yards. No, they're not just the dink and dunk isn't as it seems to be able to elude guys in space.
Yeah, what Wilmington's going to have to make a couple changes. Coach is good at that. Make a couple changes. That the quick pass, especially the guy coming across the middle, is really a pain in the neck.
Second and 10. Wallace in motion. Handoff. And he's tackled in the backfield. Handoff to Geno Hess, and he's going to end up losing about 5 yards.
Let's see, one, two.
Try to catch Wilmington off guard. Been thinking pass, 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 and just it's one thing you don't do against Wilmington is run the football.
That's pretty difficult. You've just got to out-manhandle them if you're going to run on them because they are quick and strong.
Third down and 16 for the Patriots. Three receivers to the far side, two to the near.
5:50 left in
Hess
the game.
In motion.
Kind of quarter.
Pass down the middle of the field and just overthrows his receiver. Excellent coverage by the Wildcats on that one. Fourth and 16. Let's see what they do here. They're in that kind of no man's land.
Yeah, I think they'll probably. I'd be surprised if they don't go for it. They have. The capabilities of picking up 8-10 yards pretty quickly, and I don't know if I would do that, but I think they will.
They now have four receivers to the near side.
Because they got to get about 16 yards.
They have all five receivers on this side of the field. But motions. Here's a pass down the sideline, incomplete, flag in the backfield.
It was holding by the guy that was coming our way, trying to seal off the end. Might have been number three he was holding.
Let's see what happens. Hold penalty is declined. First down, Wildcats. So Wildcats will take over on first down on the 43-yard line for the Cats. So one play, two plays, five plays. Well, how many plays do we get another touchdown here from the Wildcats? They've ran two plays from scrimmage for how many yards?
I'll check it out here for you. Let me see. 31, 59, 90 yards.
For 90 yards. Two plays for 90 yards. That's an average. 45 yards.
45 yards a carry, yep. There we go.
All right, so Wilmington comes up to the ball. Double wing. Oh, we got a flag on the play. Not sure what's going on. Peoria has an extra guy out on the field. So, too many men on the field, so that'll give Wilmington a 5 extra yards there. So, first and 5 for the Cats. Well, maybe they thought the extra guy would help them out a little bit.
Yeah. Tell you what, if I was in their shoes, I'd sure lobby for it, I'll tell you that.
All right, Wilmington comes up the line, double wing set. Hawkins on the far side, Weaver on the near side.
They're getting smart and putting a guy deep now, the safety back there.
Hand off to Hawkins. He's going to cut it up the middle. Good blocking. Breaks the tackle and ends up with the first down. Picks up about 14 yards. Gets a first down. Spot the ball on the 42-yard line, looks like.
He was held to 14 yards that time.
That's going to kill his average.
That's not nearly 45, is it?
No, not at all. All right, so Cats come to the line. Double wing again.
Look at the way the defense stands up. Interesting.
Hand off to Hawkins. He's going to kind of weave through his blockers, cut back.
Uh-oh.
First down. He's going along the sidelines. He's going to get pushed out of bounds. See where they mark it at, about the 20.
About the
18-yard line.
Wildcat first down.
24-yard gain.
That'll help out a little bit.
Wow. Did you see they changed their defensive line that time? They didn't get down in the three-point stance. They stayed up kind of leaning on their knees so they could have and back about a yard from the line of scrimmage. Try to get a little time, I guess, to read the play.
Yeah, read the play. Keep it in front of them kind of thing and
and
be able to attack it because Wilmington's going to run at you up the middle. They haven't ran to the outside too much. All right.
Now they're
double
down.
Double wing. Looks like Treadman. Nope. There's a pitch to Weaver. He's going to pick up about 3 yards.
He's up about 3 yards. We'll bring up a second and long, 7
for Wilmington. He's got a total of 61 yards for tonight. 59 his first carry, and 3 his second carry. And you can see some of the changes that the Patriots are making is working. They're beginning to eat into those runs now.
Wilmington still double wing. Treadman looking over the defense. Hand off up the middle to McWilliams, I think.
Brett McWilliams on the carry.
He's going to pick up about 2 yards.
A couple of yards. We'll bring up a third and 5.
So third and 5 for Wilmington. McWilliams is going to come out. Is this going to mean Preto will go in the game? I was not paying attention to see who went in. That's what it looks like. Yeah, Nick Preto is in at fullback.
Yeah, that
Hawkins on the far side. Hand off to Hawkins. Gets behind his blockers, cuts it to the outside, breaks a tackle, takes it to the 10, the 5, dives in. Where are they going to spot?
Touchdown.
Touchdown. Touchdown, Wildcats. Took a while there. Refs looked at each other and took a second there to call a touchdown, but touchdown, Wildcats.
He does such a nice job of following his lead block, and then he can turn it on, and he just got, like, afterburners come on, and he jets out to the side and comes on. Cuts the corner off and gets the touchdown. 14 yards.
So Alex Hinton for the extra point. Snap, kick. It's up and it's good. So Cats will take a 21-7 lead with 3 minutes and 37 seconds left. Really quick, we got some scores from around the area. An interesting one is Lyle nothing, Byron 14. Is that in the first quarter still, or it didn't say?
It's probably the first quarter.
A couple other ones: Jacob 6, Lincoln Way East 7, Plain. Is it, what's this one here?
Plainfield North
7, Main South nothing, Coal City 0, Marengo 7, Hersher Mantino nothing yet on that. Okay, so some interesting scores from around the area. So let's see if we. I don't think we'll get a commercial in. We went over scores, and I don't think we're going to get a commercial in really quick. So we'll just hold off, and Cats will kick off.
I'm interested to see if Coach Rince made a few changes in the defense now and continues to kind of smother them in there.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see. Looks like they're switching their the receivers for the kickoff around. They put Hess. They put Hess on this side and moved Hughes to the other side of the field because he's kicked it. Because Hatton's kicked it off to the side both times. So Hatton back to kick. Patriots set to receive. Kick. It's up and it's going to kind of go. He just puts it right back over to Hughes. He's going to run it, get a couple decent blocks, but runs it to his own player.
Yeah, he did. Man, right smack into his own lineman there, brought him to a screeching halt.
First down and 10. On the 30-yard line for the Patriots. So Patriots, key for the Patriots here is just stay in this game. Don't they showed at the beginning of the game they can pass the ball on the Cats. They just need to keep that going. Hope, you know, the coach doesn't make too many adjustments. But here we go. Patriots lined up in the shotgun. Hess behind Blake. Here's the handoff, and it's just snuffed out.
Weaver
just comes right through untouched and looks like he's going to go for about a 6-yard loss. Second down and 15, 5-yard loss.
5-yard loss?
Yeah, five. Sorry, I messed you up there.
Boy, Weaver was through that line of scrimmage so fast. By the time he got the ball, he was already on his back.
Yeah, it was barely even got the ball. So here we go. Two receivers to the far side, two to the near. Blake under quarterback, Hess off to the side. Motion by Wallace.
Got two guys on defense over here.
Pass out to Wallace. He's going to run it up the sideline and probably make maybe a yard out of that whole play. A lot of motion, movement, but not too much.
Well, Wallace had caught three passes previously for 20, 12, and 15 yards. That time he's down to about a 1-yard gain. Maybe might have been 2 yards. I don't know. Maybe I should give him another one.
All right, here we go. Three receivers to the near side, one to the far. Begner at quarterback. Calling out the possible blitz by the Wildcats. Snap.
What's that?
Drop back for a pass underneath. Ball looked like it was tipped, and then it is dropped by number 7, Tyler Gregory.
Boy, and there was wide open in that slanting pattern. Again, was Jaron Wallace. He was wide open cutting across there again.
Yeah, it looks like they had him bracketed kind of, but he was in that no man's land between where the would-be safety and back released them, and the safety would pick him up.
Now, surely they will not go for this.
So
you're still in the game, 21-7, though it's the first quarter, 2:40 left. I would presume that they're going to go ahead and kick the ball. It looks like it.
Punt. Looks like Quinn Miller. Is that number 5 to punt? Hawkins back to receive.
That's dangerous. Hawkins is allowed to run that back.
Snap. Kick. Line drive. Off to the side. Looks like it might take a bounce out of bounds at about the 32-33-yard line. So, Cats are able to hold them this time and come back. Offense is going to come back on the field. And 2 minutes, 32 seconds left in the first quarter. Cats are up 21-7. Patriots able to figure a little more out about the Wildcats offense last time. Didn't score off that one play. It took them a few plays to score, but let's see if the Cats made any adjustments.
Yeah, they had done some shifting in their line from standing up, hands and knees, down to close in to the offensive line with their helmets. And it looks like now they're going to get down in a regular position.
Wilmington comes up, double wing. Hawkins in motion. Hand off to Weaver to the far side. Weaver cuts through. It looks like he's going to go to the outside, and he's going to be gone. Maybe angle. Nope. Touchdown. Touchdown, Cats.
Wow.
It looked like the defender might have had an angle on him, but Weaver just put on the jets and was able to score a touchdown there. So.
I was like you. I thought maybe he was going to cut him off because it looked like he was going to have a chance, and then Weaver just turned on a little more juice and left him right behind. That was a nice show of speed.
So that first minute of the game was kind of confusing. Yeah. So Wildcats will go here for the extra point. Hatton back to kick. Treadman to hold. Snap. Kick is up. Oh, this thing's clobbered.
Got it.
That's good. Hatton had a leg and a half into that thing.
Yeah.
So here's your score. Wilmington Wildcats 28, Peoria Heights 7, 2 minutes, 20 seconds left in the first, and we'll go ahead and cut to commercial.
Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop specializing in top-of-the-line customer service. Warren's accepts all insurance companies, and they offer free estimates, certified technicians, and a lifetime written warranty. Plus, Warren's will set you up with a rental car while your vehicle is in the shop. So the next time you need work done on your vehicle, call my good friend Warren at 815-458-3300 or stop by Warren's Collision Center at 242 North Front Street in Braidwood. You can also check them out online at warrenscollision.com. Warren's Collision Center, where they care beyond the repair.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chappell back here. We got catch the score to another touchdown. They're up 28-7, 2 minutes, 20 seconds left in the first. Alex Hatton set to kick off.
It looks like Coach Rentz has made a couple changes on defense. And they're showing off that crossing pattern, though, was still open last time.
So Hatton's kick. It's up. It's going to go downfield. Looks like nobody's there. And it's picked up by number 44, Geno Hess, at about the 5-yard line. He gets to the outside a little bit. And so he's going to be pushed out about the 20. It's like about 22-yard line.
Well, he did make a little yardage by picking up. I thought he should just let it go, but he was going to go into the end zone for 20.
Right, the first time, 20-yard line, closer to 20.
No, it is a 20-yard line.
Yeah, 20-yard line. All right, so back in shotgun is Wagner. One receiver to the near side. Three, one to the far. Looks like they're going to tighten it up a little bit. Hand off to the side. Gonna break it to the outside. Cuts back. And, he just gets taken down. But he still picks up about 5 yards on the play. Just a twist and turn for number 44, Hess, who ran the ball about 5 yards. He's got some good
speed.
Yeah. A little bit, he can break a tackle.
You don't want to let him get around the corner. Definitely. If you do that, you're in trouble.
So it looks like Peoria has gone to more of a strong set with only two receivers now, one to the far side, one to the near.
I think that's a pretty good idea because that's with their slanting pattern, they can get a guy open.
Bagner back in shotgun motion here by Hughes. Hand off up the middle. Oh, now he cuts it out to the outside to Hess. Hess is going to take it for a first down, and even more. He's going to be pushed out right around the 50-yard line into the Peoria Heights bench. Let's see what's trying to get through the mess of the bench over there and straighten everything out. Looks like
that's about 22 yards. That's going to help his average.
49-yard line. Peoria Heights 49-yard line.
I'm going to give him credit for about 22 yards on the run. He gets around that. We just said that. If he gets around that end there, he can really scoot.
And he is only a sophomore.
That's what's amazing, isn't that?
Sophomore, 5'8", 170 pounds.
He's got two more years to run like that.
So,
wow.
Comes up, quarterback.
They've got some real weapons.
Two receivers at the near side. Motion again by handoff up the middle, and this one's going to be just stopped.
Yeah, back to the line of scrimmage.
No gain. It looks like they might give him a quarter of a yard. Just barely move it over. Give him a yard, I guess.
Oh, he can be kind, huh?
Yeah.
He got probably right about a foot, maybe. Maybe 8 inches a foot. His real strength is going outside, boy. He can really fly.
Yeah, not a lot of – I mean, he has some power. I've seen some videos, some video on him. He has some power, just not getting through the concession of the middle of the Wildcat defensive line. So three receivers to the near side. Quarterback back in shotgun for Peoria Heights. Motion by Hess. Pass deep down the field to nobody. Nobody is there. Pass it between two receivers.
That's one. Evidently, he just got rid of it.
Just threw it down, I think, between two receivers, hoping one of them would try to go for it.
Yeah, that's about all you could hope for there, because it wasn't really close to either one of them, and the defenders was as close to the ball the receiver was.
All right, so third and nine for Peoria Heights. Three receivers to the near side, one to the far side. Two to the far side. Pegner in shotgun. Hughes in motion. Pegner rolling out. Little screen pass to number seven, but he looks like drops it. He was going to the ground anyway. It's really hard when you hear the footsteps and you kind of curl up a little bit.
It's kind of floating to you. It's not really a zinging pass.
Right. Nothing you can run and catch with. Something you got to stop, wait, catch. It's kind of low. So fourth down and nine for Peoria, and they're going to be forced to punt again.
Yeah, I
28 seconds left in the first.
I believe I go ahead and pick it. No tricks. I kick it. I mean, no tricks, because you're still somewhat in the game. So they can score. They've got some speed.
Sure. Don't know. Snap. Yep. Trick play here. Toss up. Not sure what that was.
They were giving their. Man, a chance to run into the ball, but they weren't looking.
Yeah, it was. This is like a.
So what do you put that down? Interception.
Back, lob up. I guess it's an interception forward.
An interception by the kicker. Who in the world is the kicker? Well, did they have Gene Hess back there, Gino? Is that?
No, I'm not sure. I didn't. I couldn't tell. It wasn't the normal kicker. Sorry. I've never seen that play again.
All right.
Before, not again. Never seen that play before.
I'll put an interception.
So Wildcats on offense. First and 10, 22 seconds left on the first quarter. Double wing formation. Hand off to Hawkins. Hawkins up the middle. He breaks the tackle, and he's gone. There's nobody. He's going to catch him. 10-5, touchdown. There was did you blink there for a second?
Wow. Where'd that start at, the 40-yard line? That's another 60-yard run.
Another 60-yard. He's got to help that average. Kind of hurt it when he only had 14. So Hawkins with another touchdown run tonight. So Cats are up 34-7 pending the extra point.
It looked like that was Jose Perez that was trying to run him down. And a junior offensive line, defensive line guy, he was really flying after him. He was staying with him stride for a while. That's saying quite a bit.
All right. So here is the extra point. Snap to Treadman, kick by Hatton. It's up, and it looks good.
I don't know. We're going to wear out our kicker.
So Wilmington 35, Peoria Heights 7, 11 seconds left in the first. We will get out of this first, I guarantee you. So we'll play a commercial, and we'll be right back.
Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop specializing in top-of-the-line customer service. Warren's accepts all insurance companies, and they offer free estimates, certified technicians, and a lifetime written warranty. Plus, Warren's will set you up with a rental car while your vehicle is in the shop. So the next time you need work done on your vehicle, call my good 58-3300 or stop by Warren's Collision Center at 242 North Front Street at warrenscollision.com. Warren's Collision Center, where they care beyond the repair.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chapel. Just really quick before the kickoff, we got some score updates. We got Marengo 14, Cole City nothing. It's still in the first. Lyle nothing, Byron 14. Mantino 14, Hersher nothing in the second. So here we go, Alex Hatton to kick off. Kick is up, low line drive kick. It's going to bounce. Try to pick it up, and he does. Run up by number 9, Hughes. He's going to take it out to about the, you know, mark him out at 49. So a really good return for Peoria Heights.
I'll tell you what, that guy can fly too.
That low line drive kick looked like it was going to give him some problems, but he picked it up and he just went. Didn't want to get that kick a little further up in the air. So Peoria Heights will come out. We have 5 seconds left in the first. So hopefully one play, maybe two, and we'll be in to the second quarter. So Cats are up 35-7. Peoria Heights comes out. One receiver to the far side, one to the near. So they're going to go back to kind of a power set for them. Snap. Here's just a ball up in the air to number 3 and just right off his fingertips. Kind of did a stutter step and was able to get past the defender, but this ball went right off his fingertips, and we have 0.5 seconds.
I thought we'd surely get in the first quarter left. Then, but we didn't. There'll be one more snap in the first quarter, and then the first quarter in this game is going to be history. Second down, 10 yards to go from the 48-yard line.
Let's see what they come out with now. Looks like they're going to come out with 2 receivers to the far side, 2 to the near. Oh, 1 receiver.
Yeah.
1 receiver to the far side.
I tell you what, they got
to the near.
They got some guys with some speed.
Yes, they do.
Man, I tell you.
Begner back. Shotgun. Snap. Drops back. A little pressure from number 9. And the ball is dropped. Just incomplete right off Geno Hess. So that's the end of the first quarter. Score your Wilmington Wildcats 35, Peoria Heights 7. Be right back after some word from our sponsors.
Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop specializing in top-of-the-line customer service. Warren's accepts all insurance companies, and they offer free estimates, certified technicians, and a lifetime written warranty. Plus, Warren's will set you up with a rental car while your vehicle is in the shop. So the next time you need work done on your vehicle, call my good friend Warren at 815-458-3300 or stop by Warren's Collision Center at 242 North Front Street in Braidwood. You can also check them out online at warrenscollision.com. Warren's Collision Center, where they care beyond the repair. Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop specializing in top-of-the-line customer service. Warren's accepts all insurance companies, and they offer free estimates, certified technicians, and a lifetime written warranty. Plus, Warren's will set you up with a rental car while your vehicle is in the shop. So the next time you need work done on your vehicle, call my good friend Warren at 815-458-3300 or stop by Warren's Collision Center at 242 North Front Street in Braidwood. You can also check them out online at warrenscollision.com. Warren's Collision Center, where they care beyond the repair.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Peoria Heights, it's 3rd and 10. Receiver in motion, handoff. No, it's fake. Run up the middle by the quarterback. Spins down, picks up about 5 yards on the play. We're not. I realize I'm not even saying who's doing the tackling. So, trying here.
Was that Ty Webb that ran for 5 yards?
No, it was Begner. It was the quarterback.
Oh, it was?
Did a fake, yep.
I was looking down trying to catch up on all work here.
So, 3 receivers to the far side, 2 to the near. Begner back in shotgun. Snap. Quarterback drops back. Throws downfield. And it's, almost picked
nice
off.
Nice defense. Wow. He threw that right over him. Outstretched arms of number 24, Brett McWilliams, in his face. But he still put the ball pretty much right on course, too.
Yeah, Steve Smack almost picked that off.
That was a long throw down field as well.
So first down for the Cats. Let's first see. And 10 at the Wildcats 46-yard line.
to about 40 yards in the air from where he was at.
Well, I mean, the chain is at about.
It looks like the ball spotted about a yard behind where the chain is.
How about a measurement?
So, all right, Treadman comes out to the huddle. All right. Cats in the double wing. Preto back in at fullback still. Weaver on the far side. Hand off up the middle of the Preto. Preto's going to wind out about, grind out about 5 yards. 4 yards. Just what's nice about Nick is he's really low to the ground and just gets right through, sneaks right through there and has a lot of power. Able to push through.
Yeah, they've missed him the last few weeks. He hits a gets a quick hitter, and then he can really pick up some territory.
I'll tell you, when he was at Hershey, he was picking up some really good chunks yard.
Yeah, he was.
All right, Wildcats are going to come out in like a spread. Two receivers on the far side, one to the near. Handoff up the middle of the Preto. Preto breaks a few tackles. Good. The flag on the play, possibly a hold. Let's see where they... He has the first down pending the flag, holding on the Cats.
That's their first penalty of the night.
So he picks it up, throws it back a little further.
Mark it at the 47-yard line. And so they're going to go 10 yards back from that.
28-0? No, I don't have that one.
It says Lyle Bell,
28-0. Wow.
So I just got a score update. Lyle is now down 28-0.
Really?
So Wildcats will be 2nd and 12 from the Wildcat 43-yard line. 2nd and 14. Check that. Cats come up this time in the double wing. Kind of confused me there when they came out with three receivers.
Yeah.
All right, handoff to Weaver. Weaver cuts through, breaks a tackle. Breaks another, cuts it to the outside. He's breaking tackles left and right, and he's gone. To the 10, the 5, touchdown, Wildcats. Touchdown, Wildcats, Owen Weaver.
Man, I'm having trouble keeping up with this here.
Got caught up in a little congestion there, but was able to break a few tackles and just take it all the way home. Once the Wilmington backs were getting to the outside, they are just going untouched for a touchdown. So Cats up 41-7. 9 minutes, 59 seconds left in the half.
He's got 176 yards so far tonight.
Hatton for the extra point. Treadman to hold. Snap. Down. Kick is up. Looks good. It's good. So Wilmington takes a 42-7 lead with 9 minutes, 59 seconds left in the second. So go ahead and do a quick commercial and be right back.
Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop. Breezer Construction Company is a proud supporter of Wilmington Wildcats football on the Christian Internet Sports Network. For over 30 years, Breezer Construction Company has led the way in providing quality construction to the industrial, utility, and pipeline industries. For more information on Breezer Construction Company, go to breezerconstruction.com. That's breezerconstruction.com or call 815-521-0900.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Wilmington's up 42-7, 9 minutes, 59 seconds left in the second. We got a quick score update. We have Lyle down 28-0 to Byron. Byron is leading, so that's who the second round opponent for the Wildcats would be. Byron would be traveling to Wilmington.
Wow. I didn't expect them run over Lyle like that.
All right, kickoff by Hatton. Nice high kick this time to Hughes. Hughes is going to take it up to 20. It's spun around at about the 32, 33-yard line. So, interesting. Just Lyle really came on pretty hot, and Byron is shutting him down pretty good, 28-0. Not sure where that's at in the game.
Second,
Second quarter, I was just told.
4 minutes left in the half.
It's very interesting. All right, so Peoria Heights comes out. Three receivers on the near side, all clustered together. One to the far. Wagner back in shotgun. He's got time, throws a pass to number three, catches it. It's going to pick up about 17 yards on the play.
Wallace on the reception.
Jaron Wallace on the reception.
For Patriots.
17 yards.
Huh? Yeah, that's what I'll give him.
That play is open 90% of the time. Just that little slam across the middle.
So ball on the Wildcats, 49-yard line. Quick snap, handoff to Hess. Hess is going to go up the middle, pick up maybe a yard. Hess is having more success when he goes outside the tackles, but they're trying to give him a little something running up the middle, and it's just the Wildcat defense. The whole internal line is just shutting them down.
Yeah, the defensive line for the Wildcats has done an awesome job. There's nothing up the middle.
It looks like they actually have fullback in now for Peoria Heights. Two receivers on the far side, one on the near.
Going to get a little protection for the quarterback, looks like.
From Wallace. Fake handoff. Short screen. Hughes. Turn around, turn, keep his legs going, and pick up about 4 or 5 yards on the play.
That's on the reception. Bring up a third down.
About third and
three
for Peoria Heights. So they were able to move the ball this time. Last couple of times they've struggled. Going to go to almost an I formation here. Handoff up the middle to the outside. He's going to break tackle and pick up the first down.
Boy, he gets on the outside. It just smokes right on down the field.
Hughes is going to end up with a first down.
A good 10 yards at least.
Ball's going to be spotted on the Wildcat 34-yard line, it looks like. It's going more of a power type set here for Peoria.
Yeah, their offense has no trouble. I mean, they can move the ball. They haven't shown they can stop
Wilmington. Hand off to Wallace. Wallace is going to take it around the end, and he's going to be stopped for about a 5 yard game, 4 or 5 yard game.
Wallace on the carry.
So second and five for Peoria Heights. 8 minutes left in the second.
They're moving the ball fairly well. They've picked up a couple little, put a couple little wrinkles in the offense.
This team is used to scoring. If you look at some of their games, they're used to scoring a lot of points. So four receivers to the far side, three of them clustered up, one way over there on the sideline. Motion here from Hughes. Hughes takes a sweep, and this time he's just going to be tackled in the backfield by Mick Williams.
Is
it 24?
Williams on the tackle. We have a third down for Peoria Heights.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I thought it was Mick Williams. You get 24 and 34 mixed up a lot. I'm pretty sure it was 24.
C.J. Davis?
No, on the tackle, sorry.
Oh, who's the runner?
It's number 7, Gregory, I believe. So four receivers to the near side, one to the far side. Begner all alone in the backfield, looking over to the sideline for possible play.
Going to call a timeout.
We're going to call a timeout. Who's going to timeout for Peoria Heights?
Yeah, the play clock was running out. It actually did run out as they were calling the timeout. Well, right,
so
they have,
we got a score update really quick. Mantino 21, Hersher 7. Marengo 14, Coal City 7. I think we brought you that one before. So we're going to want to run a quick commercial.
We could do that one more commercial. We'll be right back.
Ricchetti's Cafe and Pizzeria in downtown Coal City is an authentic Italian restaurant that's all about sharing great food in a relaxing atmosphere. Ricchetti's has delicious paninis, sandwiches, calzones, salad, pasta, and of course, their incredible pizza. Plus, you can check out a game on one of their many TVs, and they have Wi-Fi too. Stop by Ricchetti's Cafe and Pizzeria today at 375 South Broadway in Coal City.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chapel, and get the Wildcats in the lead 42-7, 6 minutes 56 seconds left in the second quarter. So Peoria Heights comes out. They have four receivers to the near side, one to the far, third down and about 7 for them.
I'd blitz me a guy in there this time. I don't know if you're going
to. Back to snap, a little pressure on the quarterback. Quarterback puts it up. Hawkins on the inside is able to pick this one off.
The pass is intercepted by Nick Hawkins.
Let's see where they're going to spot this. It looks like it might be on the 1 yard line.
Wildcats will take over about their own 1 yard line.
So 99 yards to go for the Wildcats. 42-7, Cats lead.
Wow. I was trying to figure out how many passes I had down here.
They've pretty much, they had a couple runs this last time, pretty much sticking with the pass. And they, I mean, they had some success with it, but not being able to continue it. So Cats line up, double wing, okay. Hand off to Preto. He's able to come out and pick up about 14 yards. First down for the Cats, first and 10. Ball on about yards. The 15-yard line.
What did I do with Mr. Preto here? Oh.
Cats come up, double wing again. This one stopped. It's getting, Peoria Heights is getting more and more people right up there at the line. Preto on the carry again. This one picks up about a yard or two. But Peoria Heights is just getting, they're deciding to clog the line of scrimmage. It's just, it's hard to tell who the, especially they're all way down on the one end of the field, so trying to pick up who they're handing the ball off to.
They have a lot of speed on the backfield and corners to try to cut off a run around the end, so they want Wilmington to run up the middle, but so far that hasn't worked exactly well overall either.
All right, Wilmington comes out, double wing. Pitch to Hawkins. Hawkins is around the outside, and he's going to be taken down. So it looks like probably a first down. Yep. First down for the Cats.
First down, Wildcats.
Ball on the 25-yard line, first and 10.
Did you see how many yards he got that? Was that a 5-yard run, or was that a?
Yeah, we'll give him 5. Sounds good to me, right?
Yeah, right.
He won't mind affecting his 200 yards rushing for the night.
Yeah, he's going to be close to that here for a long. He's about 148.
Kits come out, double wing. Hawkins, Weaver. Hand off to Weaver to the near side. Cuts back, breaks the tackle. Ooh.
Oh, he almost got loose.
One guy to get past, but he still picked up a first down. Got about 11 yards on that carry.
Boy, that last guy, if he hadn't stuck his hand out there, tripped him. He'd been gone for another touchdown.
Shoelace tackle, right?
Yeah, just got a shoelace on him.
All right, so Cats first down.
5 minutes, 10 seconds to go in the half. Cats up 42-7.
Cats come out, double wing. Hand off to Hawkins. Hawkins cuts back. Just gets slipped up a little bit there and gets about a 5-yard carry.
Yeah, what he did was he hopped over a guy and he went to make a cut, and his foot slipped out from underneath him, and that allowed him just enough time to get him. They're quick. You got to get past them when you have the opportunity. If you hesitate, you don't get it.
You'll get more hands on you, and that's exactly what happened. Here we go. 4 minutes, 27 seconds. Clock's just rolling. Pass, but Treadman backfield pass to Smock. Smock catches it wide open. He's going to run down the sideline, and this is going to go. Steve Smock with a touchdown.
Touchdown. What a pass from Jeff Treadman to Steve Smock.
Treadman to Smock for, what was that, about a 60-yard touchdown?
59 yards.
59-yard touchdown pass. So Cats are up 48-7 pending this extra point. Treadman to hold.
There it is.
Hatton for the kick.
Boy, that was.
Snap. Kick is up. It's good. So Wildcats take a 49-7 lead against Peoria Heights. 4 minutes, 11 seconds left to go in the half. Halftime for Marengo, Coal City is Marengo 14, Coal City 7. I don't think we've got any other scoring updates. So we'll go ahead and play a quick commercial and be right back.
ACN representative Pete Treby has a very simple way for you to save money on your monthly bills. All you have to do is go to Pete's website and fill out the free analysis form. Then Pete will show you a detailed way to save money on everything: wireless, satellite TV, high-speed internet, local and long distance, computer support, and coming soon, save money on energy. Go to the sponsors page on this website, click on ACN representative Pete Treby's link, fill out the free analysis form, and start saving money today.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chapel, filling in for John, who's down in Tennessee. So Alex Hatton set to kick off. Cats up 49-7, 4 minutes left in the half. His kick, kind of low. Bounce it. Neither one covers it, and this one's going to go back into the end zone for a touchback. Both returners kind of looked at each other, and one took off, thought the other one had it, and he just watched the just some confusion in the backfield. So Peoria Heights will start at their own 20-yard line.
Well, let's see if they can Cats can stop them one more time before the half here. By the way, they start second half with the running clock because they got 49-7 at the half. They have to get one more touchdown.
No, it should be good. We're up over 40. We're up over 40 at the half.
Because it's 42-point lead, yeah.
So Peoria Heights comes out. Two receivers to the far side. Back in shotgun. It's Begner. Drops back to pass. Pass over the middle and just bounces it in there. Really good arm. Just short. So second and 10.
He's 50% of his passes. He's 10 for 20.
Like you said, those short passes, they've been there for him. It's just a matter of locating it, and that'll come with, you know, another after this year. He's only a junior, right? Yes, he's a junior.
Junior?
He got a good arm for a junior.
Oh, yes, he does.
Back in shotgun, motion. Hand off to Hess. Hess is going to go nowhere. He might even lose.
I think he's going to lose a little bit, a couple yards. A
couple yards. It's a problem with handing off in that shotgun. If it's not effective, you're going to lose some yardage. So third and about 12 for Peoria Heights. Three minutes, 43 seconds left in the half.
Hess has run nine times for 33 yards.
Nine times for 30. Most of those were to the outside. So three receivers in the near side, one to the far. Hess in the backfield. Snap back to Bergner. A little flare pass to number three, Wallace, and he's going to be just taken down by
Boy, that's Weaver.
Weaver. So fourth down, he's going to give him about 2 or 3 yards on that reception. So about fourth and nine for Peoria Heights. 3 minutes left in the half. See what they haven't substituted anybody in. It looks like they're going to go for it, fourth and nine. Yeah, let's see what they do. Let's see if they do that with a weird play again.
That weird play or try to draw them offside.
7 seconds left on the play clock. They're just going to let it run down and call a timeout here.
Not give Wildcats any more time than they have to.
So
basically, they're right at 9.5 yards, might as well say 10 yards for a first down. So,
timeout for Peoria. They have one left. Wildcats still have three, but with that timeout, we'll go ahead and take a quick timeout and play a commercial, pay some bills.
Quigley Technology Services is your local source for computer help. They have built numerous websites, including ours here at the Christian Internet Sports Network. Quigley Technology Services also specializes in virus removal, so your computer will get back to full speed now. And you can trust them for first-class computer repair, including free local pickup and delivery, plus on-site service, including after hours. Contact Quigley Technology Services at 815-293-7844 or stop by at quigtech.com. That's Q-U-I-G-Tech.com.
Welcome back to Christian Internet Sports Network. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chappell here at Becker Field. And the Cats are up 49-7 with 2 minutes 30 seconds left in the half. So let's see what's going to happen here. They come out. Looks like they're going to go for it here on 4th and 9.
I guess they figured they had nothing to lose, I suppose.
Motion the guy to the backfield. It's a snap back. And it was going to be a pass, but he just gets taken down by Mick Williams, number 24, and end up losing yards. And Cats are going to get the ball back about the where are they going to spot that? About the 18-yard line?
Yeah, they lost about 8 yards on the play. They're going to be about the 12-yard line, 12 or 13 maybe.
Looks like it was set up to do a double pass, kind of a trick play, and some discipline, and Wildcats able to snuff that out. So you have and 10 out at the Wilmington or the Peoria Heights 11-yard line. So one of the shorter fields for the Cats tonight. Double wing. Hand off to number 20, Dustin Kelly. So we got some reserves, some backups coming in.
Yeah, he was running over the top of somebody and lost his footing and went down. Give him, 2.5 yards, huh? All right, clock continues to run. 2 minutes, 9 seconds and counting.
So, looks like we have Mendoza. Is one of the handoff to Dustin Kelly, and he's going to take it down to about the 1 yard line, pick up a first down for the Cats.
The 1 yard line, first down, Wildcats.
So first down on the 1 yard line, 1 minute 50 seconds left in the half.
Clock continues running. I suppose they just didn't want to give up the ball. Well, they were down 49-7 as it was. So
false start on the Cats.
False start. Second penalty. This is going to happen when you start subbing in. And so it's kind of a normal normal problem.
Yeah, a little bit of confusion there. 1 minute, 27 seconds left in the half. See if the Cats can't put another quick score up on the board.
Got number 99 in there as well.
Sam Jones, number 99. There you
go. Sam Jones, yep.
Pitched.
Look at that wide open hole.
Dustin Kelly in for a Wildcat touchdown. Able to take it 6 yards. You're right. The middle of that field just opened up, and there was no cutting back needed. He just ran. He could have walked straight into that.
Yeah, he saw that. Nose went right straight through. 1 minute, 4 seconds left. Catch up 55-7, waiting the extra point.
All right, Treadman to hold, hat and the kick. Snap, kick is low. He's going to miss this one. So, Cats stay 55-7, 1 minute, 4 seconds left. Going to go over some score updates here. We got Byron 35, Lyle nothing, Mantino 28, Hersher 7. Marengo 14, Coal City 7. No updates on that one yet. No updates on that one either. So go ahead and throw a quick commercial on and come right back.
All right.
Teresa's Styling Salon in Wilmington is a casual, family-friendly salon that caters to people of all ages. Teresa's provides everything from haircuts to perms to manicures, and they can highlight or color your hair for that special look. Teresa's is located in the Southgate Plaza on Water Street in Wilmington. Call today for an appointment at 815-476-1955. That's 815-476-1955.
Welcome back to the Question Internet Sports Network. And we're back here. We got about 1 minute left in the half. Cats are up 55-7 over Peoria Heights. It got ugly pretty quick there.
You know, you're kind of in a trouble for the second half because their offense, Peoria Heights, is really so fast and good. I don't know if Wilmington's second unit defense can keep up with that or not. That'd be interesting.
Kickoff by Hatton. Nice high. Going to fall a little short and miss it on the bounce. It's going to go out of bounds, but the receiver got a hand on it. So
I thought so.
Yeah, it looks no flag, so it looks like they're going to mark it at the, about the 10-yard line.
Halftime score at Byron. Byron leading mile 35-0
So Peoria Heights, let's see what they do here the last minute, 4 seconds.
What are they going to be at, the 10, 11, 12? 12-yard line, maybe.
So let's see. They're going to line up just two receivers, one on the near, one on the far side.
Because they might just run it up the middle one time, or maybe even kneel time.
Shotgun. Hess behind him. Motion. Hand off up the middle of the Hess. Hess is going to break through a tackle. Ooh.
Boy, he almost got clear through.
Hawkins came up and was able to – was able to tackle him, but he gets by Hawkins, and that goes for a touchdown.
Yeah, he was gone. That was a nice run. He only got 3 yards there, but boy, he was threatening to go a lot farther.
He starts 5 yards back.
Maybe close to 4 yards.
He got about 4 yards. Starts 5 yards back, so he gets that head of steam going and goes pretty good. So,
well, he sure does.
Two receivers on the near side, none to the far. Hess in the backfield. Back in shotgun snap, handoff up the middle, and he's going to get eaten up by the interior of the Wilmington line.
There just hadn't been much in the, up in that middle of that line that Wilmington has given up.
That should be the last play of the half. Wilmington's should be taking a 55-7 lead in the half. We'll see what they do. They might stand around. Nobody's going to the sidelines. No,
quarterback's talking to their official. He's not going to do anything.
All right, here we go. So that's the end of the second quarter. You're Wilmington Wildcats 55, Peoria Heights 7. So we'll play a couple commercials. We'll come back with a halftime show sponsored by – who's our halftime show sponsor?
What's that?
Warren's Collision Center.
Oh, yes.
Phelan Acres Bible Church is the perfect place if you are looking for a church to call home. They have services every week, including Sunday school at 9:45, morning worship at 11, and Wednesday night prayer meetings at 7. Phelan Acres Bible Church is located at 26009 Willow Lane in Wilmington, Illinois. And for more information, call 815-476-7818. That's 815-476-7818. If you're looking for more information on Wilmington Wildcats football, then check out the Catbackers every Wednesday at 7 at Tuffy's. Each week, Coach Reince goes over game film, takes questions from the audience, and presents the Offensive and Defensive Player of the Week awards. Plus, you'll get to hang out with other Wildcat fans and get the inside scoop on next week's game. So be sure to check out the Catbackers every Wednesday at 7 at Tuffy's. If you need something done around your house, chances are Beth's Busy Bees can get it done. They specialize in residential and commercial cleaning, but they can also do lawn care, small home remodeling and repair jobs, and even things like caregiving. Beth's Busy Bees is a small, family-owned business, and they will treat you right every time. Call 815-685-9111 for Beth's Busy Bees today. Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop specializing in top-of-the-line customer service. Warren's accepts all insurance companies, and they offer free estimates, certified technicians, and a lifetime written warranty. Plus, Warren's will set you up with a rental car while your vehicle is in the shop. So the next time you need work done on your vehicle, call my good friend Warren at 815-458-3300 or stop by Warren's Collision Center at 242 North Front Street in Braidwood. You can also check them out online at warrenscollision.com. Warren's Collision Center, where they care beyond the repair. Breezer Construction Company is a proud supporter of Wilmington Wildcats football on the Christian Internet Sports Network. For over 30 years, Breezer Construction Company play in providing quality construction to the industrial, utility, and pipeline industries. For more information on Breezer Construction Company, go to breezerconstruction.com. That's breezerconstruction.com or call 815-521-0900. Ricchetti's Cafe and Pizzeria in downtown Coal City is an authentic Italian restaurant that's all about sharing great food in a relaxing atmosphere. Ricchetti's has delicious paninis, sandwiches, calzones, salad, pasta, and of course, their incredible pizza. Plus, you can check out a game on one of their many TVs, and they have Wi-Fi too. Stop by Ricchetti's Cafe and Pizzeria today at 375 South Broadway in Coal City. ACN representative Pete Treby has a very simple way for you to save money on your monthly bills. All you have to do is go to Pete's website and fill out the free analysis form. Then Pete will show you a detailed way to save money on everything: wireless, satellite TV, high-speed internet, local and long distance, computer support, and coming soon, save money on energy. Go to the sponsors page on this website, click on ACN representative Pete Treby's link, fill out the free analysis form, and start saving money today.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network halftime show, sponsored by Warren's Collision Center. Right now, the Wildcats have a 55-7 lead on Peoria Heights. Go over some quick stats here. Nick Hawkins is 7 rushes for 153 yards. Dustin Kelly is 3 rushes for 17 yards. Brett McWilliams looks like he's got a 2-yard rush. Nick Preto, 3 for 20. And Owen Weaver, 5 for 187. That's an average and a half there. So 19 attempts for 379 yards. Jeff Treadman threw one pass to Steve Smock, I believe it was, for 59 yards. Let's see. And on the Peoria Heights side, we have Blake Begner. He is 2 yards rushing for minus 2 yards. He has, trying to find it here, 21 passing attempts. He's completed 11 for 119 yards. I don't know why, but it just seemed like he had more than 119 yards that last half. Even though the score only says they've got 7, they've had some success with some short passes and being able to run after the catch. Geno Hess, who's their star running back, is 11 for 37 yards. John Wallace had 5 yards rushing, and Tyler Gregory had -1. So some pretty interesting stats for the half for Wilmington, Peoria Heights. I think it's kind of, I hate to say, what was expected. However, when the game started out, Peoria Heights went blow for blow with Wilmington. You know, after they fumbled the ball, Wilmington scored a touchdown off the first play. They get back, they do a drive, and they score another touchdown. So it's kind of thought this was going to be a little bit better game than what it's turned out to at the half. Wilmington, like I said, is up 55-7. So maybe I can get my color commentator to join me a little bit, and we'll talk a little bit about that first half of football. The problem is we get bribed with pizza. Oh, yeah. Oh, let me turn you up here.
Well, I think the overall statistic that really stands out is that you had Wilmington with 438 yards, and the Patriots end up with 163. And of those 163, 43 of them was one stab, and they scored their touchdown. So once that touchdown was scored, they had just a little over 100 yards, 120 yards for the half. And Wilmington really has pretty much been able to move the ball whenever they wanted to. In fact, they've already, before the half was over, they already started bringing in some of the reserves to run the ball for the last touchdown and kind of take the pressure off the Patriots. Kind of been interesting. I'm looking at the second half, and I'm wondering, with the speed that their offense has, both at quarterback, the wide receivers, if we do what we normally do and put in our substitutes to do the second half, can the substitutes keep up with the speed of the starters from the Patriots? That'd be an interesting comparison.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what they do, because they struggled a little bit at the beginning, was able to stay with the Peoria Heights defensively. And once they did, they pretty much had shut them down. A couple plays here and there, a couple first downs back and forth. But other than that, Wilmington's pretty much answered anything offensively Peoria Heights is able to do. Now, like you said, you put second stringers in. Let's see how they do. I think you have to. You have to rotate them in. You're up 55-7.
Oh, yeah. You've just about got to.
They score quick, but, I mean, one of the things is they really haven't stopped Wilmington defensively. So you hope your backups would be able to sustain some drives, run some time off the clock. You'll have a running clock on top of it. So the Cats should be able to have no problem to put this one away in a timely fashion.
No, I don't foresee any particular problem. If you can't win a 55-7 lead, you're going to be in bad shape, aren't you?
Yeah, I don't know if it's ever happened where someone's actually lost a 55-7 lead. So.
No. Yeah, really, the offensive unit for the Patriots, very impressive. I mean, they can really do some work. They have trouble running up in the middle. But most people against Wilmington do have trouble running up the middle. But around the ends, they can really.
That was one of the things I noticed on film with Peoria Heights, is that they were able to, their running back, Geno Hess, he was able to make some people miss, and just hasn't been able to have that tonight, to be able to make people miss and get into space. So, but we've seen once he does get into space, he's got the jets.
Yeah, he does.
Pull away from the defense.
He can really move out with the ball when he gets around the end. And the two receivers, number three, Jaren Wallace, does a nice job of getting open and receiving. He's got 70 yards and six catches. Did a really nice job. And the guy that's a good matching bookend for him is Tyler Greary over there, number seven. He had only one catch, 10 yards. But when he can get a hold of the ball, he can move too. So that's kind of an interesting. I can see why a lot of schools have had trouble with them, as far as that goes.
Yeah,
they can't score.
If you don't have the speed to match up against them, most of the time you get a lot of power of the running back spot. But if you don't have the speed to match up against them, I can see how you'd have some problems. But that's one good thing about Wilmington is Wilmington has the speed and have had the speed on defense.
Oh, so. And it was fun to watch. Coach Rentz make the adjustments during the first half of defensively. They put the pressure back on them and kept those runs to a minimum, and the pass receptions got harder to come by.
All right, let's go ahead and take a little break. And we've got about 4.5 minutes left of the half halftime, and we'll come back and bring you the second half of the football game.
Quigley Technology Services is your local source for computer help. They have built numerous websites, including ours here at the Christian Internet Sports Network. Quigley Technology Services also specializes in virus removal, so your computer will get back to full speed now. And you can trust them for first-class computer repair, including free local pickup and delivery, plus on-site service, including after hours. Contact Quigley Technology Services at 815-293-7844 or stop by at quigtech.com. That's QUIGtech.com.
Turn Teresa's Styling Salon in Wilmington is a casual, family-friendly salon that caters to people of all ages. Teresa's provides everything from haircuts to perms to manicures, and they can highlight or color your hair for that special look. Teresa's is located in the Southgate Plaza on Water Street in Wilmington. Call today for an appointment at 815-476-1955. That's 815-476-1955.
Phelan Acres Bible Church is the perfect place if you are looking for a church to call home. They have services every week, including Sunday school at 9:45, morning worship at 11, and Wednesday night prayer meetings at 7. Phelan Acres Bible Church is located at 26009 Willow Lane in Wilmington, Illinois. And for more information, call 815-476-7818. That's 815-476-7818. If you're looking for more information on Wilmington Wildcats football, then check out the Catbackers every Wednesday at 7 at Tuffy's. Each week, Coach Reince goes over game film, takes questions from the audience, and presents the Offensive and Defensive Player of the Week awards. Plus, you'll get to hang out with other Wildcat fans and get the inside scoop on next week's game. So be sure to check out the Catbackers every Wednesday at 7 at Tuffy's. If you need something done around your house, chances are Beth's Busy Bees can get it done. They specialize in residential and commercial cleaning, but they can also do lawn care, small home remodeling and repair jobs, and even things like caregiving. Beth's Busy Bees is a small, family-owned business, and they will treat you right every time. Call 815-685-9111 for Beth's Busy Bees today. Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop specializing in top-of-the-line customer service. Warren's accepts all insurance companies, and they offer free estimates, certified technicians, and a lifetime written warranty. Plus, Warren's will set you up with a rental car while your vehicle is in the shop. So the next time you need work done on your vehicle, call my good friend Warren at 815-458-3300 or stop by Warren's Collision Center at 242 North Front Street in Braidwood. You can also check them out online at warrenscollision.com. Warren's Collision Center, where they care beyond the repair. Breezer Construction Company is a proud supporter of Wilmington Wildcats football on the Christian Internet Sports Network. For over 30 years, Breezer Construction Company has led the way in providing quality construction to the industrial, utility, and pipeline industries. For more information on Breezer Construction Company, go to breezerconstruction.com. That's breezerconstruction.com or call 815-521-0900. Ricchetti's Cafe and Pizzeria in downtown Coal City is an authentic Italian restaurant that's all about sharing great food in a relaxing atmosphere. Ricchetti's has delicious paninis, sandwiches, calzones, salad, pasta, and of course their incredible pizza. Plus, you can check out a game on one of their many TVs, and they have Wi-Fi too. Stop by Ricchetti's Cafe and Pizzeria today at 375 South Broadway in Coal City. ACN representative Pete Treby has a very simple way for you to save money on your monthly bills. All you have to do is go to Pete's website and fill out the free analysis form. Then Pete will show you a detailed way to save money on everything: wireless, satellite TV, high-speed internet, local and long distance, computer support, and coming soon, save money on energy. Go to the sponsors page on this website, click on ACN representative Pete Treby's link, fill out the free analysis form, and start saving money today. Quigley Technology Services is your local source for computer help. They have built numerous websites, including ours here at the Christian Internet Sports Network. Quigley Technology Services also specializes in virus removal, so your computer will get back to full speed now. and you can trust them for first-class computer repair, including free local pickup and delivery, plus on-site service, including after hours. Contact Quigley Technology Services at 815-293-7844 or stop by at quigtech.com. That's Q-U-I-G-Tech.com.
Teresa's Styling Salon in Wilmington is a casual, family-friendly salon that caters to people of all ages. Teresa's provides everything from haircuts to perms to manicures, and they can highlight or color your hair for that special look. Teresa's is located in the Southgate Plaza on Water Street in Wilmington. Call today for an appointment at 815-476-1955. That's 815-476-1955.
Phelan Acres Bible Church is the perfect place if you are looking for a church to call home. They have services every week, including Sunday school at 9:45, morning worship at 11, and Wednesday night prayer meetings at 7. Phelan Acres Bible Church is located at 26009 Willow Lane in Wilmington, Illinois. And for more information, call 815-476-7818. That's 815-476-7818.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chappell getting ready to start the second half of Wildcat first round playoff football game. Wilmington currently is up 55-7 over Peoria Heights. Peoria Heights will be kicking off to Wilmington from the north to the south. It's been a very interesting first half. Started out kind of looked like it might have been a little bit of a battle after touchdown, and Wilmington just pulled away after that and just put the pedal on the gas and just didn't stop. So back to receive for Wilmington. Looks like get the back up. So Mendoza and Dustin Kelly back to receive for the Cats. Number 7 to kick off. For Peoria Heights.
And then what you want to do if you're Peoria? You're down 55-7. You get the kick off.
Onside kick, right?
Oh, boy. I don't know if I even want to try it.
I'm just kidding.
Oh, get as far away from the touchdown as possible.
They are. I don't know what they're doing. Lining up three-way. Yeah, it is an onside kick. Kind of bounces around, picked back up, and dropped to the ground. Looks like it's picked up by, is that 61? Yeah, number 61 fielded that, Robert Shields.
Yeah, Robert's not used to handling the ball a lot. There really was nobody around him. He could have advanced the ball into 5 yards probably. But he just wanted to stop the play and get the ball turned over to Wilmington and let the offensive go.
You're down 55-7. I don't know if it's the best thing to do is onside kick it to a team just put 55 points on you.
I'd want to kick it back there as far as.
We got number 16 in at quarterback, and I'm not sure who that is. It's not on any roster I have.
Is that the sophomore quarterback?
Yeah.
I can check it up here.
All right. Pitch to Mendoza. He goes around the far side, picks up about 4 yards.
Let's see.
So second and 6 for the Wildcats.
Is it number 16?
That's what it says. But
oh, yeah, right. We don't have a 16 on either squad. Let me try over here. Well, freshman again.
Cats will come up to the line, double wing. Pitch to Kelly. Cuts back. Picks up, got a flag down, another flag down. They struggle. They're going to go ahead and just blow it dead. Picked up enough for a first down, but I'm guessing they're going to have some holding after about 3 yards and then 10 more yards down the field. You got another flag. I'm not sure if you can have a face mask there or what.
Oh,
we got a scoring update. We have Marengo 14, Coal City 10.
Well, we'll put it this
way. I missed the penalty. So it's like maybe they're offsetting, so repeat the play.
Well, I checked on your quarterback, number 16. We don't have a 16 on the varsity. We don't have a 16 on the sophomore. We don't have a 16 on the freshman.
Who is the sophomore quarterback? What does it say?
Oh.
So I'm going to guess that's who it is. If I had to guess.
Sophomore quarterback. Jonathan Golson.
Yep. Hand off to Mendoza up the middle. He's going to go ahead and break this one for a first down. Pick up about 10 yards. Ball's down at the Peoria Heights 41.
What do you guess for yardage?
About 10.
Jonathan Golson, she said, is who it is.
Okay, you remember that, all right?
Oh, I'll be glad to. 16, Jonathan Golson.
So, cats are just taking their time. Clock's running. Hand off up the middle to, can't quite tell who that was. So I got backups in. Josh Jones with the carry.
Josh Jones.
Picks up about 6 yards.
When did he run it? Was he running from the
fullback spot?
Was he? That's just what I was wondering, if he was running from the fullback spot. I thought he might be doing that.
All right, so yeah, just cats just gonna drive the ball. Yeah, pretty boring if you're just watching. If you're looking for high flying offense, this isn't what you want. This is just gonna be methodical, 4 or 5 yards, maybe a little bit more. Go handoff, Kelly. Kelly gets hit.
Boy, some guy came back there, number 66, maybe.
Kelly's
that was Jacob Tinkman. Tinkham
picked up a couple yards there. About 2, third down and 3, 7:57 left in the third. Cats are up 55-7.
All right, let's see. Yeah, they're milking that clock right on down. Of course, that's what they want. Both teams want that done right now. Just get through this.
Cats come up to the line of scrimmage. Hand off up the middle to Jones. Jones is going to be just short of the first down. Fourth down and 1.
Well, he got about, well, between 1 and 2 yards. But
see what they do here. Probably going to go for it. Kind of short. Long to field goal, short to punt.
Yeah, I think they'll go for it. It is a little bit long for the field goal unit. So I don't think they'll go for field goal. They're going to go for it. Well, let's see. We got down, interrupt in 7 minutes in the third quarter.
Cats come up, double wing. The quarterback sneak up the middle. He's got that and more. And first down for the Cats.
He crossed over the 30-yard line.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to go ahead and about to the 29. So he picked up 2 yards.
Let's see. That's Mr. Goldman, 2 yards.
So, like I said, just a couple yards here and there. Keep the clock going. Get out of here. And from the sounds of it, worry about Byron next week.
Yeah, it looks like it. Byron's really trimming the sails soon.
Come up. Hand off to Kelly. Uh-oh. Kelly fumbles. Picked up by Peoria Heights, number 3, and he's going to take that back for a touchdown. Jaron Wallace.
That's the way you catch up fast. Who's our poor guy that fumbled that? Is that
that was Kelly, I believe. Dustin Kelly.
Oh, that's poor Dustin.
So Peoria Heights adds another touchdown, 13:55. Pending the extra point.
That isn't the way you make your coach happy.
No, not at all.
That wasn't the forced fumble.
Another score update. Mantino 35, Hersher 7. All right, so extra point. Snap. Kick bed. Pitch up the middle. It was.
They were going to try to go for 2.
Try to go for 2. kind of snapped it back to the holder. Holder then tossed it forward, but Wildcats were all over it and snuffed it out. So Wildcats 55, Peoria Heights 13. We'll take a quick commercial break.
If you're looking for more information on Wilmington Wildcats football, then check out the Catbackers at Tuffy's. Each week, Coach Reince goes over game film, takes questions from the audience, and presents the offensive and defensive player of the week awards. Plus, you'll get to hang out with other Wildcat fans and get the inside scoop on next week's game. So be sure to check out the Catbackers every Wednesday at 7 at Tuffy's. If you need something done around your house, chances are Beth's Bees can get it done. They specialize in residential and commercial cleaning, but they can also do lawn care, all home remodeling and repair jobs, and even things like caregiving. Beth's Busy Bees is a small, family-owned business, and they will treat you right every time. Call 815-685-9111 for Beth's Busy Bees today.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chapel. Cats are up 55-13, 6 minutes left in the third quarter. It's like they're going to do this if they're onside kick it. Line up three people around the football and decide what direction it goes in. It's going to go back over and it's going to fall on it for the Cats. Cats are going to have the ball about the 45-yard line.
Yes. Take over.
It's like number 70 for the Cats recovered that. Tyler Golson. Cats start at 45-yard line, first and 10.
I had a question about that. That play just had their run for two-point conversion. Yeah. Why isn't, if they're going to run for two-point conversion, why isn't when he takes the hike – that he can advance the ball from his knees?
He wasn't. He was squatting. I noticed that. I was like, Did you notice that? That's a weird position. Yeah, he had neither knee. He was squatting down and you're right. If once they snap it back and I don't know how that works, to be honest with you. With a snapper for bad snap and stuff like that. Here's the handoff. We have a false start on Wilmington. A couple backs going at the same time.
Also, the left tackle was moving.
Everybody was moving.
Oh, my. That's their third penalty of the night.
All right. So, first and 15 for the Cats. Four minutes left in the third.
That's a nice luxury to be able to pull your starters for the whole second half. Set them down. Don't have to get them banged up.
Let them rest.
Yep.
But Byron has the same thing from what it sounds like.
Oh, yeah.
Cats are in double wing. Handoff to Mendoza. Mendoza on the far side. Looks like he's going to get back to the original line of scrimmage. Pick up about 5 yards on that.
Mendoza on the carry. Picks up 5 yards for the second and 10 for Wilmington.
Second and 10 for Wilmington. It's my fan club in front of me here.
I noticed that.
So that was my sister-in-law and my fiance, and my mom's up there. Just, you know, I get followed around.
Fiance, when are you getting married?
I'm getting married in May.
Oh, really?
Yeah, May 7th.
Congratulations.
Thank you. All right, Wildcats come to the line, second and 10. Hand off up the middle to Jones, I believe.
Oh, boy, that's a nice hard run up the middle.
Picks up about 9 yards, 8-9 yards. So you're going to give him about 8. So third down and 2 for Wilmington. 3 minutes left in the third.
Was that Josh Jones?
I
don't think he's the right number. 29. I got to have a 29 somewhere.
Is it 29?
They said this is about Jones in the PA system, but
yeah, 29. That's what it looks like. You're not able 29 on there? No, that's
all right.
Got another flag on the Cats. I'm going to guess it's a legal procedure again. Yep. So that'll push them back from third and 2 to third and 7.
All right, let's go back over here. Oh, they're on there. They're not. They're wearing different jerseys entirely.
So we got another score update. Marengo 21, Coal City 10 in the third quarter. So watching that Coal City game, Coal City struggled a little bit there towards the end of the season. Went and played undefeated Marengo. Marengo, who is one of the two teams that beat Byron, I believe, this year.
Oh, are they? Oh, boy. Sounds like that would be a tough job.
All right. Cats come out double wing again. Hand off this time to Kelly. Kelly breaks it up the middle for the first down and more.
Wow. A nice run.
About 17-yard run on that. Wildcat first down. 2 minutes left in the third quarter. Cats up 55-13. It's a running clock, which is kind of nice.
Oh, who was it? Mendoza?
Kelly.
Oh, Kelly.
Ran that.
Man, I got to look to see who it was. Well, we're down to 139 and still counting. Going through that third quarter.
Plays left in this half, or quarter, I mean. And
get this. We got almost a quarter used up. The Patriots haven't run a play yet, and they got score.
Oh, another legal procedure against the Cats. Pushing back 5 yards, so first and 15. Just giving everybody a little playing time.
Coach is talking about
what do you mean two running backs can't be in motion at the same time? I don't understand.
He talks to me while we're off the field.
Since when did that come? So Cats will be back out there. We're probably not even going to get two plays. Now we're going to get one play. 50 seconds left in the third quarter. Cats come up the line. First and 15. Hand off to Kelly. Kelly up the middle and stopped after about 3 yards. So a 3 yard pickup for Dustin Kelly. Third and 12.
Third and 12 it is. 22 seconds going. Counting down.
That should be quarter for us. So at the end of the third quarter, Wilmington Wildcats 55.
Oh, what? That solved the problem.
What's that?
Can our defense even keep up with their offense? They never wrote a play.
No, exactly. So Wilmington Wildcats 55, Peoria Heights 13. So we'll go ahead and play up a couple commercials and be right back.
Warren's Collision Center is your hometown body shop specializing in top-of-the-line customer service. Warren's accepts all insurance companies, and they offer free estimates, certified technicians, and a lifetime written warranty. Plus, Warren's will set you up with a rental car while your vehicle is in the shop. So the next time you need work done on your vehicle, call my good friend Warren at 815-458-3300 or stop by Warren's Collision Center at 242 North Front Street in Braidwood. You can also check them out online at warrenscollision.com. Warren's Collision Center, where they care beyond the repair. Breezer Construction Company is a proud supporter of Wilmington Wildcats football on the Christian Internet Sports Network. For over 30 years, Breezer Construction Company has led the way in providing quality construction to the industrial, utility, and pipeline industries. For more information on Breezer Construction Company, go to breezerconstruction.com. That's breezerconstruction.com or call 815-521-0900.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Dustin Kelly on the carry. Looks like they can give him about a yard, not even quite back to the original line of scrimmage. So third and 10 for the fourth and 10.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Fourth down.
It was third down, was down there. It came down here. It was second down. Now they got it back to third down. I don't know what it is. Up in the scoreboard, it's got fourth down. Maybe they're trying to.
Third down is what they're indicating. I think we missed a down here somewhere. So handoff to number 13 around the outside. He's just going to get bottled up. Lose a yard.
Flood on the carry.
He's going to lose about a half a yard. So now we got fourth down and 11. Wildcats. Looks like they're just going to go for it. No reason to punt now, right?
I don't see any reason for it. Might break it loose and keep the offense off the field for it. Oh, for the Patriots there.
Yeah, Patriots. So hand off up the middle. Breaks it loose. Going to get the first down. It looks like got a flag. Late flag comes in. Real late flag. We got a hold, looks like, on the Cats. Yep, sure enough. Hold on Wilmington. That'll bring it back.
So we give him credit for a 7-yard run, and he comes back, and we lose it all.
Well, that and more. So now.
And we lost.
Fourth and 15.
And we 14, lost 3 more yards.
Fourth and 14 for the Cats. So fourth and 14 for the Cats. 9 minutes, 46 seconds left in the game. Cats are up 55-13. This game purely in hand for the Cats. Cats in the double wing again. Hand off to Mendoza up the middle. He just gets stuffed. It looks like he lost the football too. Yep, he lost the football. Peoria Heights recovers. It was fourth down anyway.
Takes over.
Yeah. So Pure Heights will take over at the 40-yard, their own 40-yard line. First and 10. 9 minutes. Got any scoring updates for me? Nothing yet.
All right.
All right, so Pure Heights has four receivers to the near side, one to the far.
All right, here we go.
Begner and shotgun. Back for the pass, flag, and it goes up. Long bomb over the top of the head of the receiver. Had him open down the sideline. We got a flag, though. Looks like illegal formation on Peoria Heights.
Oh, so I'll wipe that pass attempt off the boards here. I saw that pass receiver. He outdistanced the defensive guy by 3 yards.
Yeah, had he connected, it would have been a touchdown, but not sure what's going on. They're talking to our coaches, their coaches.
The legal procedure
is what they're going to call it.
All right. That clock continues 8 minutes and counting.
It's a nice thing about the fast clock. It don't matter, penalty, whatever. It's going to keep running. So three receivers to the near side, one to the far, Begner and shotgun. Hand off to Hess around the outside. Back to the original line. Scrimmage a little bit more. Hess on the carry picks up about 14 yards. Gets around that outside and is able to make something happen.
Boy, he can do it quite frequently. He's a sophomore running back. Man, I can't hardly believe that. Guy can really run the ball.
All right, this time four receivers to the far side, one to the near. Begner in the backfield.
This is a chance to go for the long one because it's short and second short yardage.
Hess in motion. Hand off to Hess. Counter to the outside. He's going to get that first down. He's going to break a tackle. Finally, after the first down, gets taken down after about a 7-yard pickup. First down for Peoria Heights.
Starting to rack up some yardage against the subs. He's got 21 yards and two carries, the last two carries. Now he only had 37 the whole first half.
All right, Peoria Heights comes back out. Three receivers on the near side, two to the far, back up. Passes up in the air. It's up, and jump ball comes down and ends up hitting the ground.
Good defense.
Good defense by number 20 of the Cats, Dustin Kelly. He's able to come down and knock that ball loose as they're both him and the receiver were going to the ground.
Yeah, he went right up with the receiver, was right with him, stride for stride, went up with him and pulled the ball loose as they were coming down.
First, I thought he'd have an interception, but just couldn't wrestle it away. Here we are back, shotgun snap. He's going to roll out to the far side, pass it downfield, and it's going to be deflected.
There
it
is, another nice pass play, another pass defense. What was that, 23?
So have they answered your question about whether they'll be able to keep up with this offense yet?
I'm impressed.
They're doing a halfway decent job. Yeah,
I'm very impressed.
Not really so going far with the man coverage. Like, looks like more of a zone coverage for the Cats. 5:34 left in the game. Third and 10 for Peoria. Begner drops back to pass, gets some pressure, rolls out, throws one up downfield to number 3, and he catches it for a first down. Jaron Wallace. Jaron Wallace. Is that about a
20?
Yeah, about a 20-yard reception. Three receivers to the far side, two to the near, Begner and shotgun. Snap, drops back to pass, throws it out to number 5, and he's going to slip to the ground after about a 6-yard pickup. Tyler Gregory. Three receivers to the near side, two to the far, Begner and shotgun. Motion, handoff, the outside, it's going to turn the corner and slips and falls. Just couldn't get a good footing trying to turn the corner.
And he lost about a yard doing it.
That was number 9, Jalen Hughes.
He carried the ball once in the first half for 5 yards, and this time he lost one this half.
Snap. Quarterback scrambles, throws it up to number 9, catches it, Jalen Hughes, and he's just tackled by a host of Wildcats.
Nice defense.
Give him the little underneath stuff, but just not being able to break away like they did a little bit in the first half of the game. So 4th and 5 for Peoria.
I think he actually lost the yard or so.
Of course, they'll go for it, and nothing to lose here. The 4th and 5, pretty close to the... Back for a pass. Pass right underneath the number 3. Collides with a couple, and he's going to keep his feet. Ooh.
Ball's out.
Ball's out on the ground.
I think Wilmington's got it. He hit him a good lick and knocked the ball loose, and I think he then recovered the fumble.
Yep. Wilmington ball. Jaron Wallace caught that ball, really tried to get a touchdown and stayed on his feet and just took a good lick and fumbled the football, and Cats recover. About the 1 or 2 yard line.
That was about a. Oh, who caught that ball?
Number 3 is what I thought it was. Yep.
Okay, that was a 19-yard game, but he ended up coughing up the ball. Got it up to date now. We're down to 2:50 left in the game, and our little subs held it out.
Yep. 55-13 Wildcats. 2:40 left in the game. Double wing, handoff up the middle. Gets out to about the 10-yard line, just short of a first down. Final from Lyle or from Byron. Byron 42, Lyle 7.
Oh, wait, for the sake of my
So that means that Byron will be coming to Wilmington next week. We'll have times and everything for you when we find out.
You remember who ran that last play?
Oh, I didn't know. I was handoff off to the near side, and it's just a scrum anymore.
Wow.
Subs coming in and out for both teams.
Number 17. We don't have a 17 either, I suppose.
Like I said, just put backups. You know, you get a lot of kids dressing that don't normally dress in the playoffs and getting a chance to get in there. And unfortunately, we still have the regular season roster. So 1 minute, 20 seconds left in the game. Cats take a knee.
Yeah, I think that's it.
So, another knee, too. Kents will seal this one up, 55-13. We have any more scoring updates? Nothing. Let's see the final. Nope, I don't see anything else has changed. Nothing else from Coal City Marengo. Plano plays tomorrow. Bishop Mack plays tomorrow. That's someone else in Wilmington's quad that, you know, you can't look over Byron, but somebody else in our quad that we have to worry about. Wilmington takes another knee, and that'll do it. 18's clock winds down, 16, 15 seconds left on the clock. So Wilmington with a first-round win, 55-13. So let us go ahead and get our stats together, final stats of the game, come back and go over there those and talk about the game a little bit and maybe talk to Coach Reince.
Ricchetti's Cafe and Pizzeria in downtown Coal City is an authentic Italian restaurant that's all about sharing great food in a relaxing atmosphere. Ricchetti's has delicious paninis, sandwiches, calzones, salad, pasta, and of course, their incredible pizza. Plus, you can check out a game on one of their many TVs, and they have Wi-Fi too. Stop by Ricchetti's Cafe and Pizzeria today at 375 South Broadway in Coal City. ACN representative Pete Treby has a very simple way for you to save money on your monthly bills. All you have to do is go to Pete's website and fill out the free analysis form. Then Pete will show you a detailed way to save money on everything: wireless, satellite TV, high-speed internet, local and long distance, computer support, and coming soon, save money on energy. Go to the sponsors page on this website, click on ACN representative Pete Treby's link, fill out the free analysis form, and start saving money today. Quigley Technology Services is your local source for computer help. They have built numerous websites, including ours here at the Christian Internet Sports Network. Quigley Technology Services also specializes in virus removal, so your computer will get back to full speed now. And you can trust them for first-class computer repair, including free local pickup and delivery, plus on-site service, including after hours. Contact Quigley Technology Services at 815-293-7844 or stop by at quigtech.com. That's quigtech.com.
Teresa's Styling Salon in Wilmington is a casual, family-friendly salon that caters to people of all ages. Teresa's provides everything from haircuts to perms to manicures, and they can highlight or color your hair for that special look. Teresa's is located in the Southgate Plaza on Water Street in Wilmington. Call today for an appointment at 815-476-1955. That's 815-476-1955.
Phelan Acres Bible Church is the perfect place if you are looking for a church to call home. They have services every week, including Sunday school at 9:45, morning worship at 11, and Wednesday night prayer meetings at 7. Phelan Acres Bible Church is located at 26009 Willow Lane in Wilmington, Illinois. And for more information, call 815-476-7818. That's 815-476-7818. If you're looking for more information on Wilmington Wildcats football, then check out the Catbackers every Wednesday at 7 at Tuffy's. Each week, Coach Reince goes over game film, takes questions from the audience, and presents the Offensive and Defensive Player of the Week awards. Plus, you'll get to hang out with other Wildcat fans and get the inside scoop on next week's game. So be sure to check out the Catbackers every Wednesday at 7 at Tuffy's.
Welcome back to the Christian Internet Sports Network. Dennis Harding along with Rodney Chapel here, and we're going to go over the stats and our sponsor. Remember who our sponsor was really quick? Trying to get everybody in. Should we have, there's no after?
Post-game, ACN Pete Treby.
Pete Treby?
ACN Representative Pete Treby.
Treby.
Yes, Pete Treby.
Pete Treby. All right.
He's an old friend of Jonathan's when they used to go to high school together.
Okay. All right, so final score here at Becker Field is 5, Peoria Heights 13. Some final stats. See if I can get through all these here.
Can you read them?
Is it just okay, you crossed them out. All right. So we have Blake rushing two for minus two. Geno Hess, 13 for 58 yards. Jalen Hughes, 3 for 3 yards. Wallace, a 5 yard. And Tyler Gregory, a minus one. Receiving, we have 20, or passing, 27 attempts, 15 completed, 164 yards, I believe that says. Total yards, 227 yards on offense for Peoria Heights. Wilmington Wildcats. Nick Hawkins, 7 for 153 yards. Pretty much these didn't change too much. They didn't. The starters were not out for the second half of the game. Dustin Kelly came in the second half, rushed 8 for 38 yards. Joey Mendoza was 4 for 19 yards. Nick Preto, 3 for 20 yards. Owen Weaver, 5 for 187 yards. Josh Jones, 2 for 7. We got some backups in, 1 for 8. Total yards for the Wilmington Wildcats tonight, 525 yards.
525.
That is,
wow,
just
that's a lot of yards.
And let's not forget about our one pass attempt for 59 there. Yards. That almost went overlooked that. But we'll have Coach Reince up here in just a few minutes. Going to kind of talk to him. We heard Byron is did beat Lyle, and did beat Lyle pretty well, 42-7. So that means Byron will travel here to Wilmington. We'll find out whether it'll be a Friday or Saturday night. Not tonight, obviously. He's got to talk to the Byron coach. But it should be interesting for the catch, a semifinal rematch from last year.
Do you have any idea of kind of offense and so forth that Byron runs?
Byron runs a straight at you. They're going to run the football. They're going to pound away at you. They don't pass the, if they pass the football once, like they're, it's Wilmington. It's not, they don't, I don't think they run the double wing. I think they run more of an option. I can be honest. Honestly, I don't remember, but I know they just run the ball. They do not pass. So, it'll be pretty much a mirror image.
Well, that could be an interesting game.
Be a very interesting game.
Because evidently both lines, they got a lot of confidence in both of their lines to do the job. I might say tonight, too, one of the things that got overlooked a lot is the offensive and defensive lines of the Cats. They opened some nice holes up in the offensive line and get those running backs room to scoot to. And once they did, they had the speed to go all the way. And the defensive line wouldn't let them run up the middle at all.
Yeah, Wilmington only had, looked like, they're reading this, 19 rushing attempts. Oh, no, a total of 30. Well, in the first half, 19 rushing attempts for 379 yards.
Boy, that's a lot of yards.
That's a lot of yards for only 19 attempts. In the second half, they had altogether, both combined, 35 for 465 yards. But still, that is a lot of yards for the Cats tonight against an opponent we have never seen, which is kind of nice about the playoffs. They changed things up a little bit. There's no more quads. It's 1 through 16 north, 1 through 16 south, and then the best of those goes in place. You don't have to worry about travel times and stuff like that. Something they're going to try and see how that works for
years
for everybody.
Gone by. There have been some terrible traveling times.
Yeah,
years
well,
gone by.
7 and 8A, they do 1 through 32, which was just weird when we were doing the playoff pairing show last week and going 1 through 32 and trying to, you know, when you read a 32 seed against the number one seed.
Oh,
so
my.
It's like, you know, you had some of those some of the bigger schools traveling from the St. Louis area all the way up to Chicago to play, you know, their you know, a 32 seed driving all the way up here to play a number one seed, and
you're probably well gonna get yourself wiped out.
I mean, it's you know, the Wildcats have the number one seed in their bracket, so that's what's good. The thing we needed to happen, though, we needed Lyle to win this week.
Yes.
Lyle wins this week. There was a good chance Wilmington would have home games going through the rest of the playoffs, the way the bracket's favored. So next week, let's, you know, you got other people in the bracket. There's Bishop Mack. There's Sterling Newman. There's all these other teams. But we have to worry about one thing, and it's Byron. Byron is going to be our next opponent. And while we've seen them a few times in the past, they've gotten a lot better this year. A lot better from last year. Last year, it was Wilmington was able to handle them pretty easily in the semifinals, and I'm sure they remember that. It's a game that you know, they upset Sterling Newman the game before that, and coming in here, they it just didn't look like a team that should, I hate to say it, that should be in the semifinals, but they got there. They just, you know, they had a bad game. We had a perfect game. So it just happens. This is the way it goes, the way football goes. You get lucky, and so we'll see what happens. Still waiting for Coach to get up here. So
strange things happen in football. Well, all the sports, I guess, but boy, strange things happen sometimes in football, especially when you get in the playoffs. Sometimes a really good team has a bad night, and they end up losing, and then the team that's left over comes out to play the next game, and then they get whacked.
Right.
Because they're not really that type of a quality team. And when they play another good quality team, they get the plow cleaned.
I did like the fact that it seemed like fumbles were cleaned up this week.
Yes. They had the one fumble that went for a touchdown. That was by the backups.
Right.
And that wasn't a forced fumble. He just kind of was.
It was a pitch that just, yeah, couldn't
get his hands around it.
Yep.
Yeah, and but I thought overall, I think Wilmington only had like four penalties. At least until we got in the second half a ways, when the subs were doing some of those procedure penalties.
Yeah.
Two backs moving the same. And the last time they did that, Coach met him out in the field and talked to him all the way to the side.
Yeah,
and there was no more of that.
Right. Maybe he had one holding penalty from the starters. And so played a pretty clean game. At the beginning of the game, I'm sure, you know, we'll talk to the coach about that, see what adjustments he might have made. You know, you capitalize on a fumble by Peoria Heights. You take it in one play, score a touchdown. You give them the ball back, and they're able to get a drive going and score on you pretty quick. It was 7-7, and so then
like an old-fashioned shootout, didn't it?
I hate to say, but like I said, going into this game, we talked, and just the stats they had put up, it makes you then think, we could be not in trouble, but this could be another Mantino game where the teams are just slugging back and forth. But Wilmington seemed to make some changes on defense. Either maybe the players calmed down, but it's
I think that's that's one of those things on Wilmington that doesn't show up on paper all the time. That's the coaching. He does a fantastic job. He and his coaches do a fantastic job of preparing and adjusting during a game. I don't think they get much better. He does that.
Yeah, they're really good about making adjustments on the fly. Maybe not putting as much pressure on the quarterback, so then they drop another person back in coverage, kind of try to cut off those slant routes were working for them, and it seemed like they stopped working for them at one point. So identified some weaknesses in the defense and moved guys around and was able to get them there and make plays.
It looked like for a while that they could do that slant pattern all day long and go as far as they wanted to go, but somehow they made a few little adjustments there, and that thing wasn't open as often anymore. Yeah, it was a fun game to watch in that respect. Boy, when they scored that other touchdown right after we scored the initial one, I thought, man, this could be a long night.
That's exactly what I was thinking. But the Cats are able to hold on to pull out and hold down the Peoria Heights offense, and 55-13. Coach Reint should be coming towards us. I think I don't see him talking to any more reporters.
He went around the side here. I think he hope he's going to get a step to come up here. Get the steps going up here. Get done, and we can close this thing up here and head on home. I wouldn't mind seeing a little bit of the World Series tonight.
I didn't get an update, and I haven't. We have. I got an update. Marengo 28, Coal City 10.
Oh, okay.
So,
Coal City 28-10. It's like Coal City is not gonna be able to pull it out. Here comes Coach. So let's have a little chat with him.
All right. Let's see.
How we doing, guys?
Hey, we're doing good. Hey, Coach, 55-13. So starting out that game, we capitalize on a fumble, we score a touchdown, and they come right back, drive on us, and score a touchdown right away. What were you thinking at that point of the game?
Obviously not happy defensively that we let the big play get us, but, you know, against those spread teams, if you have one breakdown and they find that one kid, you know, they found them, and give credit where credit's due. Their quarterback, not bad. Their running back, 44. That kid's only a sophomore, so he's going to be all right. I mean, they showed some good things. We let some, you know, and they made some good plays when we had coverage, and then we were able to contain that a little bit. But, you know, running the ball, boy, big plays. You know, huge big plays tonight. So real happy with our offensive line and our ends. the way they blocked tonight. And when you get a win like this in the first round of the playoffs, you'll take it anytime you can.
So, yeah, first half, you guys had 19 rushing attempts for 379 yards.
Oh, wow. Okay. We've never had that. And so, and they were – I'm not sure what they were doing defensively. They were trying to mix it up as much as they could. We're very fortunate to have a couple backs that can really go. And up front, we're doing a good job blocking right now. So, for us to come out, like I said, and to do that type of thing in this type of game, real happy we're home doing it. And like I told the kids, you're 1-0. Last weekend's done, and that season, now we're 1-0, and let's see what we can do next week.
It was nice to see – I saw Nick Preto back in the game, so he's back from his injury.
Yeah, we got Nick back, and even Studer got in a little bit. And so, and now I got to get the report downstairs from our trainer, but I didn't notice anybody getting hurt tonight. And if that's the case, then we'll be as healthy as we've been going into this game with Byron next week.
Yeah, say if you hadn't heard, Byron did end up winning 42-7.
Okay.
Against Lyle, so yeah, Byron will be coming here. And
okay, gotcha. And that'll be, I'm sure they'll be looking forward to coming back down here, obviously with happening in the semifinals. But we need to be able to answer their intensity. Tonight was a good playoff atmosphere, but next week will be quite the deal. So, but these are the ones you like. These are the ones that you got to come out and play for. And, they've done a nice job this season, and, it's going to be a great test for us, but we'll be up for it.
All right, Coach. Well, thank you. And we'll see you next week.
All right, guys.
Hopefully either Friday or Saturday night, right?
Yeah, we got to figure that out now when I get downstairs. I appreciate it.
Okay. Thank you, Coach Reins.
Yep.
All right, that about wraps it up. So the Wilmington Wildcats win the first round of the playoffs, 55-13 against Peoria Heights. And second round opponent will be Byron, and it will be here at home. Be sure to stay tuned to the website, to the Facebook page, and we'll go ahead and we'll put up times when we get them in. So sounds like everything went well tonight. And got anything you'd like to add, sir?
Just I'm looking forward to Byron, seeing what we can expect there. A little fear and trembling in some respects, but I think we're ready for them.
Yeah, I mean, you gotta respect your opponent. Not necessarily fear, but respect.
Yeah, I was trying to sneak in, and the coach. He was asking the coach about that punt that they threw underhanded.
I didn't even think about that.
I didn't get to hear.
I will ask him Wednesday night at Catbackers. So,
oh, good.
Wednesday night at Catbackers, we'll go ahead and ask him. Yeah. Oh, is that what he said? They're trying to draw a pass interference because it was tossed up in the air like that. Okay.
Oh, okay. Well, all right. You sign us off, and we'll be ready to call tonight.
So it's Dennis Harding and Rodney Chappell, Christian Internet Sports Network. Everyone have a good night, and God bless.